Election Day 2016. That song goes out to both sides of the party today. We are in Midtown Manhattan doing the show, and we are right in between the two political centers. Trump is up the street at the Hilton, and it's a madhouse up there today. And then Hillary's going to be at the Javis Center on the west side. I went past Trump Tower, completely surrounded by dump trucks with sand, so nobody can drive a fucking car bomb into it. And I understand that the Javis Center is the same exact way.
Well, it's great for party hopping if you can't really decide. Like, if you're like, I'll just go with the winners.
This is Jeffrey Gurian's night. This is the Bennington Show. I'm Ron Bennington. There's Gail Bennington.
Yo.
And I am Ron Bennington. Both me, you, and Chris are wearing our I voted thing.
We voted.
Like a little baby.
We voted.
When he goes to the dentist. Vito, you didn't vote today?
No, but I'm still out here rooting.
Okay, so he's rooting. Now, this is the kind of opportunities that you miss. I was 10 spots behind my hour and a half wait of a celebrity.
Whoa.
And now we start Celebrity 20 Questions. Who did Ron see in the voting line today? Chris Stangley, you get first question.
Was it a woman?
It were not a woman. Okay. So you are out. No more questions for you. Not until somebody else gets a no. That's how we're going to do it now.
God damn it.
Go ahead.
Was it a musician?
No.
An actor?
No.
Was it a comedian?
But by the way, there was someone, there were, no, by the way, no. So you're still out. There was, like, they were selling cookies and stuff, and someone said to your mom, don't I know you from Actor Studio?
What?
I go, what are you, crazy lady? No. Actor Studio. I go, I just got a SAG card last night for being in Big J's show.
Really? That got you a SAG card?
I don't know whether I get a SAG card or not, but I had to sign up with SAG.
That's awesome.
I used to be an AFTRA when I was at the other radio station.
I think sometimes you can do both.
Well, I want to do that. Yeah, because I think they brought the two together. But I'll pay the dues if I get the free movies.
Oh, well worth.
And get to make my vote count for the SAG Awards.
They do have dues in that club.
So, I'll pay dues. I've been in dues clubs before.
Oh, yeah. I love dues club.
Vito, who was I in line with?
Was it a writer?
No. Stop with the writing.
Director.
No, why does everybody just think it's an entertainer?
Was it a newsman?
No. So why would I be?
I had a guest.
Yeah, guest.
Guest.
Go ahead.
Photographer?
Yes, I was in line. I make a big deal because somebody has a picture. Look at your fucking phone. Everybody's a photographer today.
A politician?
No.
Was it Shepard Smith?
No, oh, come on, dude. I already said no, it wasn't a news guy. You should lose 3 points for that.
Break.
Is it a host of some kind?
It's from the world of sports. I'm going to give you that. The world of sports. Yeah.
Was it a New York Yankee?
No.
Was it a football player?
Player? No.
Oh,
it was a football coach?
Former. Gail?
Former football coach.
Probably don't know any, right?
No.
Bill Parcells?
No. Why would I be with Bill Parcells?
Former Giants coach?
No. Not a Giants coach.
God.
And he's got a Super Bowl ring. Looks like I'm turning over all the cards. Bill Cowher. Bill Cowher votes with me.
That's
he lives in my neighborhood because my chick saw him at the doctor.
I didn't know he was living in New York.
It's a lot of shit you don't know over in Astoria.
I don't know anything.
See, this is why you have to go out and vote.
Vito, you fucked up.
You could have been hanging out with Bill Cowher if he, of course, was in your district.
Could have made my big comeback.
How long was your vote? How long was your wait?
That was an hour.
How about you, Gail?
30 minutes.
I did about an hour.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was very funny. It was a fucking hilarious line.
Yeah, and they told me I also came just at like a really good point. There was a lull. Like, it was probably more like an hour, hour and a half, just like an hour earlier than I went. But yeah, it was a very diverse group. There was, I was like looking around. I was like, there are mostly women in here right now. It was a
there
lot.
Was a lot of women in mine, too.
A lot of women. And I thought, just like how diverse like my area is, like just every shape and size, color, you know, whatever. And I thought it was very cool that it was a woman in a United States, like a U.S. flag hijab, which I thought was like a very like I would like I live on Sesame Street.
I know you really do. I always do this, too. I am here to vote President of the United States proudly. I do that every fucking time. And every time I think, oh, my God, this is funny. I don't know why I do, but I do. I here to vote very important United States President of Freedom.
Now, does it depend on the lever, on the district, what process you use? Like if you use the lever or the
it's
bubble?
All local. Yeah.
So are you a lever or a bubble?
No, we're doing the old California fucking test where you have to write shit in. And then,
Scantron.
Yeah, and then you get to push it in that thing. It's the same way that you do with your passport.
Yeah. I miss the lever. I like the lever.
Because I think Obama, too, was a lever.
It depends, like you said, wherever you are. Levers are, I guess they can be fucked with a little easier. I don't care. I wish you could just yell out in the window of a drive-thru. I got nothing I'm ashamed of.
And all the fries you can give me.
No, all the fries you can give me. Thank you. it is it's a funny day of hell because it's always old people running it and how important they take their position that day.
Oh, yeah.
They make big fucking deal out of
they
it.
They really do.
There was a lady dressing down some young dude who like didn't know how to like read a book to find people's like district. Yeah. And she was like, listen, kid, you got to know what you're doing in here.
But I do know this. Me and Trump are in the same, I guess, congressional district.
Really?
Yeah. Whatever that thing is, he wanted on the Republican thing, he wanted all in New York except for his own fucking thing, except for his own neighbors, which I thought was great. The people who know him best are like, nope.
Mm-mm. Oh, remember that one?
Yeah.
That little one-termer.
Well, he felt bad about that, too. I felt bad for him. I don't like to say anybody.
I don't think anyone should have one term.
It seems sad. Although it does feel like this is a one-term president we're electing.
It kind of feels like that. That whoever it is going to get enough anger on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to grow some strength.
Finally get their shit together.
And they will be back with a vengeance, it is.
Or this person will just fuck up so bad that we're just going to be like, we're forced to one term. Whoever gets elected today will be like this in 3 years. Look, I gave it my best shot. I don't know what to.
It's hard. It's not easy.
That was Lyndon Johnson. Nobody could fucking believe that he was like, nope. Not going to do it. Then he went home and grew his hair real long and then died. I don't know what he saw in there. Yeah, it was terrible. The way he went out, oh, my God. Well, that whole, hey, LBJ, how many kids did you kill today?
No, I wouldn't want anyone to chant that at me.
No, I'd hate that. I'd be like, I don't know, 50?
I'm not sure.
I don't think more than 50.
They don't give me the numbers on that specifically.
Every time I hear it, I feel bad, though. I just think we need to win Vietnam. Are you looking at him with his long hair?
Yeah, I didn't realize he had long hair in his
life. Yeah, and that's like, that was like 69 or something, right? When nobody grew long hair.
That's great.
Yeah, he just fucking, I don't know what happened. He's a wild story. Then he went on to make the TV show Breaking Bad, which shocked everybody. You ever watch him do that LBJ thing?
Oh, no, I haven't.
He's fucking amazing in it, Bryan Cranston.
Does he get it down really well?
I mean, it's you forget you're watching a fucking movie. And the thing is, he's like a foot shorter than LBJ was.
He was a tall guy.
LBJ was 9 feet tall.
What?
Yeah.
Freakish.
How many coats you wearing over there?
Two.
Okay.
One is really a hoodie to a leather jacket.
Hey, I've got a special guest coming by today. Not only is this guest going to do the end of our show, but is going to hang around and do Big Brother and the Holding Company podcast, Natalie from Big Brother.
This is so exciting.
Yeah! You guys are going to be starstruck.
Big day for us.
I thought Natalie was actually a better player than most people gave her credit for.
Yeah.
I liked her a lot.
She was really, yeah. She was, she got in the showmance. I think people underestimated her.
She blew up Paulie's game.
Everybody there was in the showmance. No one ever bitches about the guys being the showmance. They bitch about the girls being in the showmance.
I mean, I think our next president might have been in a showmance and still is.
Sure. In somewhat of a showmance. Look at that, long lines outside of Jersey City.
That's nuts.
Yeah. I don't know why. I mean, I just put a fucking voting app on your phone.
You think that would be the best way to do it? Just
why?
Well, we do everything else that way.
What's the fucking difference? If I fucking make a purchase with my credit card, the credit card company has it locked into the exact cent. You know what I mean? Like, people are going, oh, they can fuck with that. Oh, those credit card companies seem like they know what the fuck they're doing.
And then instead of getting a sticker, you just get the ability to use a special emoji.
I would love that.
Oh, I love emojis so much better than stickers.
It's the modern day sticker.
It really is. It's the modern day bumper sticker.
Mitchell Walters texted me some emojis the other day. I didn't, did not expect that to happen.
Which ones?
It was a crying happy face. He was asking me who Jim Florentine and Robbie Slovic took.
No, he was just laughing like that was
yeah, laughing face.
That's what it means. It means you're laughing so hard you're crying.
Got it.
Like, he fucking feels superior to those guys. And they took the Dallas Cowboys against the fucking, what, Browns?
The Browns, yeah.
Yes. I mean, they had a locked-in vote.
He texted me, I'm in Vegas. I need to know who those dudes took. Emoji, emoji.
Of course he does. I'm in Vegas. That, like, that has anything to do with it.
You know, was he going to bet with them?
Can I tell you something?
Why?
Don't you see a lot of yourself in Mitchell?
Yes. I love it. He's the only other dude I know who goes to Belmont on a Wednesday. That's when the track's really popping off.
All right. Look at this. This got sent to me by Johnny. I told him to tweet it. We put it in, but I think he's afraid to. Now, this is a weird kind of voting, but whoever it was put my name in.
Oh, my gosh. You're a write-in.
Yeah.
Nice. Well,
let me just say this. If nominated, I will not run. If elected, I will not serve.
Why?
That's LBJ again. I can't get off the LBJ movie. I can't believe you guys don't watch it.
I haven't seen it.
I got home from the bitter end last night and watched All the President's Men till like 3 o'clock in the morning.
Nice.
Fucking great. What a great movie. I made every kid that saw that movie in the 70s wanted to be a reporter. Now they all, you know, go, I don't know what I was thinking. Reporter, where?
I'll start a vlog.
Yeah. But back then, it literally was reporting, where even now, we got three different, we call them news stations on, but there are three different opinion stations. No one's running down a story
Mm-mm.
on any of those things.
No.
They're just yelling about something, you know?
Yeah, they're just like, we've gathered some people who agree with us. Let's hear from them.
And then I'm going to bring in a guy, he's kind of stupid, but he disagrees with me, and I'm going to beat his ass for a while.
I think he's a troll.
It'd be like me inviting Vito in and talking music. Hey, girl.
Hey, girl.
That was fucking funny.
It was really funny. Last night was fun. That was such a great show.
Every night is fun, and you're going to have fun tomorrow night.
Yeah, I'm gonna be at Mateo Lane's show, the Diva Battle of the Divas, and I think
at Union Hall.
Yeah, at Union Hall.
Well, where's Union Hall?
Why?
It's like in the Park Slope kind of area.
What's their scene? Because I hear Union Hall all the time.
Yeah, it's a cool spot. It's got like a good kind of basement stage, kind of intimate.
Yeah,
cool vibe. Very cool.
We ever
vibe.
Do a show from Union Hall?
We should.
I feel like I want to do a Union Hall show. Lisa Traeger was giving me shit because we're out so much. She's like, you guys are out every night now.
We are.
We're live performing every night. And I go, well, you live perform every night. She goes, yeah, but you got a day job. I go, you go on the road. She goes, I love the road. I'm young enough that I still love the road. So fucking wild.
I adore her.
I had to sit in the fucking trailer with her while she got her hair and makeup done for an hour and a half.
Well, she looked great. She had that stage.
Really? How about the 8 seconds I got to make up? Did that fucking help? While I was fucking walking up, the lady just pounded my face, and she's like, I can't fix this. I've been triggered out. She had carpal tunnel from just fucking working on Lisa. This is Lisa Traeger. I'm not even making this up. And I hear her talking to the people who do makeup and stuff. What porn stars are you following right now on Snapchat?
What?
I got two that are fucking crazy. Tim Dillon there, you cunt. What porn stars are you following? Snapchat. Gay ones? It's fucking just holding court.
Do you kind of wish that she had given you like local theater, like summer stock makeup, like too much eyeliner on a guy? So it's my favorite thing. No, that's not what you should do.
Everybody in theater does their own makeup.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Even in Broadway. I can't even fucking believe it. I mean, you go to do a local TV station, they give you your own makeup. And you go fucking here, you know, you go to Broadway and it's just some fucking Academy Award winner. You're like, Dustin Hoffman is just putting on his own makeup. It always looks so sad to me, like a clown. Like they're here to amuse us.
I have to go out and entertain.
You know, back when we did XM, they used to provide hair and makeup for the Unmasked shows. And
really?
I'll just say this. One of the kids in the hall, we started the show like because he got a full haircut.
He got a haircut?
He used the occasion to get a haircut. Try to guess what kid.
Scott.
You would think.
That's
right?
First guess was
but
Scott.
But it wasn't Scott.
Kevin?
Nope.
My guess would have been Kevin.
So now you have a new guess, you fucking
There's
idiot.
Five of them.
Bruce.
He doesn't know. It's not Bruce.
Dave Foley.
And Dave Foley kept sending out, and this was in different days for him, steaming black coffee and just fucking pounding them.
Really?
Yeah. For like a 3 o'clock show. Pounding them while he's getting his hair cut.
Gotta get focused.
Fucking hilarious. God damn, there's a funny guy. Every one of them is funny in a different way. I think everybody's going to go crazy for this Unmasked on Friday.
It's Unmasked with Bert Kreischer. It's airing Friday at 2 p.m. East right here on Raw Dog.
Wow, you struggle with that.
That was weird.
Just say what it is again.
Unmasked with Bert Kreischer, Friday, 2 p.m.
Big J and I, before we went up last night, were sitting around talking about how much we love Bert Kreischer. Just fucking love that dude.
I love that guy. And I love, not only is like he's the kind of person, he's super funny. He's like the kind of dude you just want to be bros with.
Yeah.
But also his accent is so like familiar to me. Like it's so very like comforting. It's like that very specific Florida accent.
Oh yeah.
Which is not like a heavy Southern accent. It's like a very subtle Southern accent.
Yeah. When he was talking about how his dad is always in those fucking things with the shoes with no socks and stuff.
It was like, shorts
took me,
with like
yeah. Took me back to the middle aged fucking Florida guys who are just hilarious. Because life is a little more casual there.
That's very chill.
Yeah. It's very fucking chill. And even when you like you really can see a guy with shorts, no shirt, and a fucking sports jacket on and not get mad at him. People get furious up here if they see that.
Oh, yeah. That but would be like...
It's just rolling around down there. You know what I mean? Like, I never get mad at people for being fucking weird.
In Florida, every occasion is an open-toe shoot occasion. Like, you wouldn't be like, dude, you're going to come in here with just, like, flip-flops no. on? That's crazy.
No.
Every occasion is fine for them.
I've seen board meetings like that. All right. This is a very fucking funny thing. So, Fezzy said to me yesterday, this is Fez went to see Joe Biden. Look how close he got from this picture. So Joe Biden comes out.
Nice. Right?
And then when Joe Biden is done, Buffett comes out and fucking sings.
Buffett?
Yeah. Buffett came out and sang Changes in Latitudes.
Oh, Jesus.
Christ.
Went into a pirate looks of 40. The Fez said he was already in the truck by the third song.
I bet you ended with cheeseburger.
I would go crazy if you fucking did that. If he would have done changes in latitudes, I would have been fucking just... Fucking
How could you not stay for the whole thing?
I know, it's so weird and funny, you should stay forever.
You're Florida man, embrace it.
Yeah, man, be Florida man. Be flat out Florida man all the way through. That comes up during the MS where, you know, Christ, you're saying, I know Florida man. I've known dudes who fucking made Florida man.
It's not.
I know guys that have been hit by lightning alone that have turned into Florida man.
Oh, it was such a shock to me when I moved to New York and found out the state of Florida was just a joke. I was like, it's just a state.
It's a state where people are having some fucking fun.
It's really nice weather.
Yeah. I mean, let's face something. When you fucking, you're down there in Florida and you're partying a little bit, you're going to fucking meth up or fucking bath salts something, man. You're taking some time for yourself.
The weather's really nice, right?
It is. It's hot. And, you know, it's muggy. It's a fucking sexy type of weather, you know? Everybody's on the edge. The fucking humidity every day is quim. It's just straight quim. So people are going to, you know, they're going to get a little wild. You can't blame them. You got to love Florida.
You got to get weird down there.
Fuck yeah. You're hanging off the fucking end of the continental. You're the lowest of the 48.
Just dangling down there.
Just fucking... You might as well enjoy yourself. You might as well get excited that the 500's coming, you know? There's a football game every year that's billed as the world's largest cocktail party. Just about fucking drinking in the streets. You gotta have fun, you know?
Does any state party more than Florida?
Party, I'm going to say full tilt, because drinking is a fucking normal thing. You know what I mean? Like, early drinks don't fucking bother anybody.
Oh, yeah. Day drinking.
And, you know, you do a different kind of drinking than you do anywhere else. I mean, you're at a goddamn pool bar, right?
Yeah.
A banana daiquiri is going to make its way into... there's no way you're going to have a fucking boat drink in 40 fucking 7 states.
I think they're handing them out at the polls down there
they
today.
They should.
Get a pina colada?
Just like a little boat drinks?
I mean, there's no way you should be drinking an alcoholic drink with a fucking straw in some kind of fruit, and yet you do it.
I can't see myself getting like scotch on the rocks at the pool bar.
Oh, no, you can't.
No, you can't do that.
That would be inappropriate.
You want to have the blender going at all times. A beach bar is fucking great.
Oh, of course.
You're just getting fucking hammered. You're watching chicks go by. Yeah, shit's going to get a little nuts after that. You can't fucking blame anybody. Just roll with it. I know one thing. Down there, no one's like ashamed of like a DUI or anything.
You know, it's just like it happens.
It happens. One. Yeah. You got at least one. You're just going to try to enjoy yourself. You're in Florida. What the fuck? You seem like you'd be perfect for it with that skinny yours, Chris.
Oh, God, no. I mean, I could go there. I could probably, but I need 100 SPF. Otherwise, it's over for me.
And you don't do well with the heat.
No, the sweating is uncontrollable.
You're pretty sweaty.
Yeah.
This is up on the iBank today where all the big election night parties are here in New York City. We ought to fucking pick one.
Well, Chris Gethard's doing 12 hours on MNN. Just started a half hour ago.
Wow, very cool.
Chris Gethard.
Chris Gethard.
He doesn't have anybody in his group that voted for Trump.
No,
it was not a Trump backer there.
I feel like the human fish might could turn.
Not those little misfit toys. No way.
No, we're at the point right now. You can honestly imagine waking up together tomorrow with either one of those people president.
Yeah. I feel like Trump's going to edge her out. I really do.
Well, you know, I know you liked predicting, but it doesn't matter what you predict. We'll just have to see.
It's going to happen. It's already set in motion.
And there's two times that life feels weird. One, when you get a new president that's moving in. And this feels like by the time the person comes in, we've already had a couple months. But it's always that first day that you're like, oh, new president.
Weird.
And then new decade always feels weird. Like, oh, Like, the next time we're going to be going like this, we're in the 20s?
Roaring 20s again?
Nuts.
Is that what we'll call it? We just go back to saying the 20s?
I'm going
to
say the 20s. I don't want to be fucking stuck like I have been the last 16 years when nobody will call it anything. Because I remember in the 70s, the 80s, and 90s, we said, look, dude, it's the 90s. Get your shit together.
Yeah.
And we would say that to each other all the time. This ain't the fucking 80s, dude. It's the 90s. You better fucking be ready to rock this. You know? It was a way of slapping your friend in the face and getting shit going. Look who it is, Jenny Go-Go. Hey, Jenny.
Hey, Jenny Go-Go.
What's up, buddies?
Going to a go-go. Everybody.
I'm really looking forward to next Monday or Tuesday. It's going to be a great night.
What is the night on that?
I think it's Monday.
Monday, the 14th, 7 p.m.
I can't wait to see everybody. That's going to be a blast.
Yeah. I really wanted to fly Jonathan.
Friday.
Oh, that would have been great.
To be my surprise date, but my wife said that would be cheating.
Dude, if you did that, we would have went fucking crazy.
Yeah.
We would have lost our minds.
That or Fezzy showing up. That's one of the two things I'm holding out hope on.
Well, you never know. You never know what's going to happen. I know he doesn't lead a public life anymore.
Correct.
He's a very private man.
That's going to make it difficult.
Nor do I.
When he goes out, he puts a mask on.
That's why the show's called Unmasked.
Well, yeah, it is.
Hey, I have to come clean. I am the I'm the voter in New Jersey who cast one vote for Mr. Ron Bennington.
Well, look, I got to tell you, Johnny, that's a lot of pressure on me. You know, President of the United States.
You can do it.
Yeah.
Well, my choices were two maniacs, and my wife sat me down, and she said, instead of a Christmas present, an anniversary gift, a birthday present, my gift this year is for you not to vote for Donald Trump. So I abided by her wishes.
She wouldn't let you vote for Trump?
She asked me nicely not to.
Because she wants to have that first woman's president?
I said, maybe you should try to hold out hope that you'll be the first woman president instead.
I got news for you. I saw some people at my voting place that were pretty excited on that angle. And never gets any news on TV. But I saw women down there that were like, this could be it for us. I was like, oh, this is surprising.
Yeah,
to hear.
That is cool.
She said that there's a group out here in the burbs that is like, they were all going to wear pantsuits to the polling place, which actually made me laugh.
First of all, I'll wear a pantsuit any day. They look
that's
really
what I did. And Gail, I have a question for you.
Yes.
As a fashionista,
okay,
you are dressing Hillary for the inaugural ball. Does she wear a dress with a jacket or a pantsuit to the ball?
I've been thinking about this a little bit, and I think that she goes sequin pantsuit.
Really?
That's what I think she should do.
Like a hard rock jumpsuit?
Like a heavily sequin, like, top.
If I had my way, Marlena Dietrich, that shit, she's wearing a hat and tails. And she's just saying, hey, kids, this is who I've been the whole time.
A cane and a monocle.
Yeah. No. I saw a lot of people bitching about the fashion people bitching about Trump, saying that he's too rich to be wearing such baggy suits.
He does wear a big baggy suit.
He likes to wear. He's an off the rack guy, I think.
Well, you know what I heard about him? He hasn't buttoned his jacket since like last spring because he's wearing a bulletproof vest.
Oh, yeah.
Every one of these appearances, that's why his jackets are so big.
That makes some sense. I know that the security is fucking high here in town, and I know that they had, everybody was nervous because ISIS said some shit the other day, you know.
They call for action.
Shut the fuck up, ISIS. I'm serious. I try to get along with everybody. I can't get along with that ISIS.
They're just dicks.
They're too explodey for me.
Mm-mm.
They're too explodey.
I don't care for them.
No.
I don't think they care for me. To be honest,
they hate you, gal.
Well, yeah, they hate you for your freedoms.
They
you
hate
and
my
people
freedoms.
Of your ilk.
I don't blame them, though. You know, they're over there in that fucking heat. I'd be going fucking crazy.
Man, now I'm just imagining this sequin pantsuit. Really help him, right? Be a good look.
If that happens, seriously, then she should come out throwing confetti. Because that's just a silly fucking look. Yeah. That's a silly look.
All right, buddies. I'll see you Monday. Maybe we'll get a picture up on the marquee, and looking forward to seeing all the buddies there. It'll be a great night.
All right, peace.
All right, be good.
Chris is busy booking this. We're trying to... Well, first of all, last year we had so much fun. It actually is our favorite. I mean, this is our family holiday, Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Our family pretty much ignores everything but Thanksgiving.
Yeah. In true Bennington tradition.
And yeah, of my family, this is the only one that you got to be home for. Other than that, no one cares.
It's a holy day of obligation.
It is a holy day of obligation. And be nice to your sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Like you'll like, I'll get a thing like I'm fucking 13. Remember, be nice to your sisters. Well, I'm going to be nice to everybody, but with the teasing. Because sometimes I feel like I'm having fun, but some people take it personally.
Could be sensitive sometimes, but...
I know. I know. But you know what? I shouldn't be in there rambling and gambling and trying to make, you know what I mean? This ain't a fucking roast battle. It's a nice Thanksgiving. So anyway, that Thanksgiving, of course, has always meant a lot to us. And this Thanksgiving party means, you know, everything to us. It's just so great.
Like, of all, you know, we've had a lot of really fun live events that we've done throughout the year. But this is, like, the one that we really look forward to.
And I think we're going to turn this into game night. We're going to make a fun game night out of it.
A big family game night.
Mm. And, Chris?
Yes.
I want you on your best behavior.
I'm going to be good. I promise.
Not too sweaty, I hope?
That I can't. Well, you know what? I'll bring a second shirt. I'll bring a change of clothes.
That would be nice.
Because I could sweat through. It's very possible. I'm planning on it. I just know my body.
Yeah.
What?
You know it too well. I wish you wouldn't know it at work.
I don't know what you're trying to say.
I'm Googling sequin pants right now.
The shitty fucking thing, the server and all that kind of shit. Yeah. We've just been abandoned here anyway. Which is okay. I don't mind. At least that way we can just fucking get work done.
I've abandoned my boy.
I've abandoned my show. Give me the blood!
Give me the blood, Eli, and let me get out of here.
All right, so Richard Johnson knows the big election night parties. Let's see if there's one that we would want to go to. I mean, normally I go either to De Niro's tonight, hang out with him at his house. The Weinsteins always put out a very nice spread.
I imagine that would be a classy affair.
But I'd love to go over and party with the Trumps.
All right, Natalie White, a model, is throwing a party at Tolstoy's Lounge on West 52nd Street with Spencer Tunick. That's the
nude guy.
Yeah, he's the photographer.
Well, what's her story?
They have her just listed as a model. That's what.
Will he be taking photos?
Yes, he will.
Is she a nude model? Because that's the kind of photos he takes.
And he usually doesn't have like models like that. His thing is just usually regular folks.
You are correct about that.
Yeah, I'm just finding she's a model.
Model. Well,
why don't you put her name and put nude, and maybe it'll show up that way.
Or maybe we're just curious.
Yeah, she's a topless artist.
Yeah. Okay. So it takes that fucking long with you.
I didn't think to put it nude. And then,
never mind. Don't read off a list to us. Let's just be people today. Vito, you're so lucky you don't vote. You don't have to worry about going out to the party tonight.
Mm-mm.
Where are you going to be in the city?
I'm debating on either going by the Javits Center or going by the Hilton.
We ought to send you out this afternoon.
Oh, that's a
good
idea.
Send you out with a video camera because even if you just go to the Hilton, it's right up the street. And you can see, I mean, there's press from around the world there.
Yeah.
Around the world.
Everything is kind of a buzz. Like, even when I just got off the train, I could see there's just, like, a lot going on in Midtown right now.
Yeah. There's a little bit of barricades just going up everywhere.
And I'm unbiased on it.
Let's get a hold of Hard Rock Johnny and see if we can't put you in one of Elvis's suits and have you come out and just do, you know, Hound Dog or something. Place will go crazy.
Oh, that would be great.
rockabilly suit or like 70s jumpsuit?
You're not going to rockabilly it, dude.
Boy, Vito. Be realistic.
Oh, I have to be the Elvis that's shaped my body type, don't I?
Yes. You got to be Elvis laying on the bathroom floor, half a fucking shit out of your ass, dead for 2 hours. That's why they tell you, don't push. You know? Let it come.
Say.
Really?
Let it
come.
Oh, yeah. Don't force it.
You don't know about don't force it?
No.
Oh, my God.
What is this?
Do not force it.
Then you'll have a heart attack.
Been forced my whole life.
Oh, my God. Don't, Chris.
First.
I'm not confident when you're hard enough
for this. You're already in a bad fucking position. You're already in a bad position.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You didn't know that?
I had no idea.
Just go when you have to go. Don't.
Wait till the last second.
Yeah.
Just keep a bucket next to your couch.
Like, you kind of have to go, but you're just like, I'm going to wait just to be sure.
Oh, shit. Now I don't have to go at all. Now it's
why?
Why didn't you never know that forcing it is bad for you?
I thought you just got to get it out of you. It's not good for
you. Dude, you're going to have a fucking episiotomy in your asshole.
What the fuck is an episiotomy?
That's when they got to sew you back up again.
Oh, God.
You're moving rocks through there. You know what one of your problems is?
What?
Cheese at every meal. Every fucking meal, he's loading it with cheese.
It's just so good. It's just fantastic.
I saw him with a block of cheese and a fucking two crackers. Two little crackers. Went through it like a fucking Subway wrap.
I gotta get this dude some roughage.
Oh, no.
No, the roughage, I have no need for that.
Yes, you have nothing but need. You just proved it.
Don't push.
No, it's very fucking bad for you, Chris.
I gotta change everything.
You're going to end up having a fucking stroke from the fucking pot.
Oh, stroking out on the toilet's the worst place to stroke out.
This is what killed the king. The king died on the fucking shitter pushing it.
I can't go out like Elvis.
Dude, you're with Elvis with no hit records. You're Elvis. You're Elvis leaping over all the fucking career. I laughed the fact that you made it this fuck. You made it to your 30s without fucking realizing that you're fucking tearing your colon up every goddamn day.
Please.
This explains a lot of my intestinal problems, I think.
I know you say that, but we see you running down the hall all the time here. The show.
Oh, my God. My least favorite thing is when he comes in like, sorry, I was in the bathroom. It's like, yeah, I know. You like try to like pretend he didn't say it. He's like, took a while, but sorry, it took me so long. You know, like, I don't want to discuss further. Yeah, I'm aware you've been gone for solid 30 minutes when you said you just had to go to the bathroom.
You should try to be in there fucking taking a piss and hearing them yell, oh, sweet Jesus, what is that?
Dear God.
Unbelievable.
No more pushing for me. At least I have to break myself with the habit.
And I don't like when he says to me, I'm going to go to the bathroom. Then like 5-10 minutes later, he is texting me about something that we need to discuss. I know what's happening at that point.
I know, he's bored and he's just texting while he's fucking trying to move that cinder block down his fucking
my God.
Down his poop canal. 15 minutes on the poop canal.
If he's lucky.
I got a turd and I named it Sal.
It's accurate.
He actually yelled out once, damn, that one's wearing shoes. That's what he fucking yelled in the bathroom.
I don't know what that means.
He means it was fucking came in 6 months.
Oh, God.
Just stated.
He goes full term with his shit.
Oh, my God. He goes, I don't know why that's making me gag.
It should. He fucking gave his turn to rattle. He goes, here, you deserve it.
Fuck.
I'd Rock Johnny wants to talk to us. Johnny.
Yeah.
There will be no Chris shitting in the Hard Rock on Thanksgiving. Yeah.
Well, you always have a bathroom attendant and there have somebody to be jumping up and down on his fucking back, helping him out a little bit.
Well, maybe you can use the special green room that I have to have for Gail when she shows up 4 hours early.
Yeah, I do my own hair and makeup.
Do you really? You show up that early?
That was the best last year. Just Gail here to see you. It's like it's 10:30 in the morning. What is she doing here?
Blow drying my hairs, put my face on. I had to change clothes.
Big shoes.
Yeah.
You're the Lisa Traeger of our gang.
I am, in many ways.
Hey, girl.
Is that Gail? Hey, girl.
Jenny. We're going to pull this thing together.
Jenny.
Well, whatever you guys want. We're ready. We're ready. We're excited. We made a few changes this year. It's going to be bigger and better.
Well, the important thing is this. It's a night of fucking happiness for us, Johnny. All of us.
I hope.
This celebrates our bonds as well. Our 9/11 bonds are celebrated on Thanksgiving.
Yes, yes, they are.
This is going to be the first year where we're giving out edibles to everybody.
Really?
Yeah, get fucking high. That's our motto.
High as fuck.
When Lisa got off stage, she goes like this, I'm off to do an edible. I'm not even making that up. She did. Out the door she went. Like, thanks for staying in for my part, Lisa. Appreciate it.
Wait, that was before yours?
Yeah. She was long gone. She heard grr by the time she was out the door. Well, Johnny, it's going to be fun.
I can't wait. It's my favorite day of work of the year.
But you know, you got to adjust somebody for us, right? On the schedule.
I'm working on that.
Don't work on it, man. It's done. If you need somebody to fill in for him for 15 minutes, fucking Vito will clean off some plates.
He'd love to.
Dave, would you like to be seated at? I think Vito could handle that job. I don't know what's wrong with that guy.
Everything.
Or not Vito.
Hey, look, everybody was so fucking happy to see him at that last show that we did. They went crazy.
They were thrilled.
Yeah. And somebody said to me, they said, that was there that night, they said they never saw anybody like Earl in their life. They can't understand him. I go, I've known that fucker for 16 years. I don't understand a fucking piece of him. Yeah, that's true. That's true. There's nobody like him.
He's one of a kind. That's for sure.
Yeah.
But what a huge pop he got from the crowd.
People, why not? He's a fucking legend.
He is a legend.
He's like Bigfoot. The way he was standing, black people don't even stand like that anymore. He was standing like a 1948 fucking jazz musician. It was hilarious. All right, Johnny. Love you, pal.
You guys too. You guys hang in there today on this rough election day.
Well, you know what? Whoever wins, America wins. That's what I say. We got two great candidates.
They're beloved.
Each ready to lead us to a fucking better day. That's what I'm excited about.
Casey Pickles just sent me this. Is this what you had in mind? It's Liza Minnelli wearing a beautiful sequin jumpsuit, which I think maybe Hillary could pull off pretty well.
It's Liza back in the day?
Yeah.
She looks fantastic there. She looks like a fucking baked potato, though. I think Hillary would look like people are going to end up putting fucking sour cream on her fucking tits.
Mm. Don't mind if I do.
So if we take a break, do you want to send Vito out the scope?
Yeah.
We can pull that off?
Yeah, we can pull that off. I can bring us back from break in here.
Vito, you know where the Hilton is on 6th, right?
Yes.
Don't even bother walking over to the, 7th Avenue part. What is that, 8th Avenue there?
Yeah, it's 8th. Well, no, it's 7th.
Because I can never tell, because they get rid of one of the avenues.
At some point, yeah. But that's 7th.
And then Broadway crosses against itself.
Yeah, that gets...
I mean, you try to be on a grid, and they start this shit.
It's diagonal bullshit, Ron.
Thank you. I don't fucking need it, dude.
Straight lines, that's what I like.
Oh, I love the grid system.
Straight lines. And all the time, I'm on 6th. Straight lines. Here's a grid for you to walk.
Now, I enjoy the grid. Some people find it to be boring. I don't. I need a grid to get around.
It's practical.
I'm never lost.
Who's
so I get to Brooklyn.
What was that guy's name who did the tours, the documentary about the guy who did the
Speed Levitch?
Yeah, yeah. And he had that great thing where he was like, the woman was saying, who doesn't like the grid system? And he's just like, I don't. I don't like it. How could you not like the grid system? I kind of agree with her.
No, it's an easy system.
Got to love the grid.
Well, here's how fucked up New York is now. So there's this stupid bus that goes around where all the fucking tourists are facing in the same direction, right? So they can fucking show the rest of the people living here as zoo animals. Right. And what they do every day is they put a fake street performer at the place that they know they're going to be stuck in traffic. So some days they have a woman in a suit and she's wearing a mask. And yesterday they had a woman with an orange vest on who acts like she was fucking cleaning up.
With a push broom.
Yeah, so we're watching her. And I'm like, we're all sitting outside having a smoke, having our meeting. I go, she ain't real. That's a fucking gimmick. Because there's no one dressed like her who works for the city.
And her clothes were brand new. Yeah. They were like bright colored.
Right.
Yeah, and you're all by yourself. You're not with a crew sweeping.
And she was also a pretty white woman.
Yeah, she was.
Blonde,
she
was pretty white woman.
So we jump up and run over and start dancing around her while the tourists are taking her pictures. Well, then the tourists went apeshit wild. They were so happy. And then she got nervous and took off.
She ran away.
She thought that we were here. And then I, when she didn't go along with us, I go, we know you're fake. We know you're running a carny fucking scam right here every day.
You're a carny.
She wouldn't even look back at us.
She wouldn't. No. She was not happy that we had upstaged her, really.
We had upstaged her, and we're very fucking big. And like, if those windows opened up, we would have got dollars.
Oh, yeah.
But then I turn around while we're having this fun, and Vito was hiding behind a fucking potted plant.
He was
all
hiding.
All red-faced like a pussy. You're supposed to be our stunt boy.
It got so heated over there, and the woman looked scared. I didn't want charges to be brought up.
What was going to happen?
You got to fucking go down with us. You ride or die with your crew.
I thought you were my ride or die.
I am your ride or die, but not no. That situation got heated real
we
quick.
We rode, and he didn't ride with.
I don't even think he danced.
No.
He died.
I was dancing my ass off.
Barely.
The ride people were loving it.
They were very happy.
I was pulling out all my Broadway dance moves.
You're actually a very good dancer. You don't get enough credit for that.
Thanks.
You don't get enough fucking radio credit for that. Tom, New York, what's up, buddy?
Hey, Ron. I have a question for you. Maybe you can help me with this. A couple of times in the past, you used a phrase that I just thought was hysterical, and I can't remember it. And maybe it was just genius off the top of your head, but indulge me if you can, if you remember this. You were talking about how monkeys didn't understand where the moon went, you know, after it completes its cycle. And there was a phrase that you used, and because you used it more than once, I thought it might be, you know, one of your go-to lines.
I'm just guessing here, because it could have been anything. I never remember the show. But I know that what happened when people were exploring the world and they would come across native people,
mm-hmm.
and they knew that something was coming up where there was an eclipse, they said, if you don't give us this, monkeys are going to eat the moon. And then people saw, you know, the native people would see the moon disappearing and think that somehow the great white explorer had figured this out.
Right.
Right.
A way to have monkeys eating the moon. They're like, take whatever you want. Just stop eating the moon. But I don't even know how true that is. Now that I have a chance to say it out loud, it sounds kind of crazy. I'm going to be totally honest. A lot of times I think I just get a half a fucking thought and I run with it for a while. But I'm glad we could clear that up, Tom. If you believe monkeys eat the moon. Mr. Fred Blassie in a breakfast match.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Andy, did you hear? What a great fucking song.
It's a
huh?
really good song.
I was glad to see Andy Kaufman get a I wish Mitch Hedberg would get a song. I want all the past late comedians to get songs by R.E.M. Mr. Sam Kinison is screaming again.
By the way, the Mitch Hedberg Life in Comedy is on demand now. So how can you go to, you just search?
Search Mitch Hedberg in the SiriusXM app and it comes up.
Nice.
Sweet.
Modern, the one that came around.
He says Mott the Hoople in The Game of Life.
Yeah.
It's fucking great. You know, we just lost the member of Mott the Hoople and Bad Company, I believe. It was Mick Ralphs that passed away. Looked that up so I'm not saying something in case he has a relative. I picked the wrong person.
He had a stroke.
Oh, he had a stroke. Okay.
Yeah.
So we didn't lose him, but we almost lost them.
But he was both in Mott the Hoople and Bad Company.
That's a pretty nice fucking resume
That's
for yourself.
That's cool.
Yeah. That's two fucking bands I wish I was in. If you could only be in one band in history, what would it be? For me, it's the Go-Go's.
Just really? Like
the one guy in the Go-Go.
Mr. Go-Go, they call you.
Yeah. And I'd probably just black leather it up with a fucking cat face. What about you, Chris? Fish again?
No, it wouldn't be Fish again. Grateful Dead, I think, would be pretty cool to be in.
I can't picture you with a Grateful Dead. No, you've been too young. Who are you, John Mayer?
I would like to be the one Lady Ramone, so you could be like the only female, like the sister, essentially. Of.
I like that. You could have been Josie Ramone.
Yeah.
And they'd be like, no one starts anything with our sister. See, we're very protective of her. I don't know if there's anything creepier in life than a fucking brother who worries about his sister's sexuality.
Yeah, it is very creepy.
It's almost creepier than the dad, you know, since they're both like dating age with each
other. Yeah, I mean, like they're both creepy, but I think maybe you're right. The brother is a little bit more creepy.
Yeah, they're both creepy.
Just stop thinking
brother,
about it.
Brother, I think, is creepier because there's a higher chance of incest. I think there's more.
There's no such thing as a higher chance of incest.
I don't know,
so
man.
Weird.
That's what I feel.
Really weird thing to say that he just said.
Disturbing, and it's HR disturbing.
don't call HR, please.
That's what I call him. HR disturbing.
Get a little, but he can't get enough. HR disturbing. Chris Stanley is talking again. HR disturbing. Rita, what do you think? What band would you be in?
I mean, I think I could easily just sneak into the background of the E Street Band while 20 people are
there. He only brings one fucking pitch. You see Bruce last night singing for Hill?
No, I didn't see that last night.
Yeah, he was down in, he did Thunder Road and a weird acoustic version of Dancing in the Dark. And I forget the other one that he did. I wanted him to do it cause since he was in Philly. Well, they blew up the Chicken Man of Philly last night. I remember we were overly proud about that. The Chicken Man Tesla ended up in a Springsteen song. No, I can't picture you in the E Street Band. Those guys are unbelievable musicians. You'd have to be in some fucking boy band.
Maybe like a Blink-182. Oh, no, Third Eye Blind. I could definitely fall into Third Eye Blind.
See, I picked one that was like, I easily could pick up those songs.
I know.
Like, I could learn those songs.
Maybe I should just be in Happy Mondays. It's kind of like a party guy. I'll be with fucking...
You'll be like, what is the dude who just dances with them?
Dez?
I think it was Dez.
Well, you were the Mighty Mighty Boston.
All right.
Yeah, that guy dances too hard. That guy is fucking sweating his ass.
Tragedy.
I think that guy gets a full share in that band, too.
I think he should. He's a hype man.
I don't know. If I was sitting there fucking playing an instrument, I'm like, I should be getting paid like.
Yeah, but he really, I mean, he's really sweating up there.
I know, but you know what? A lot of people fucking sweat. They don't get a full band cut. You know what I mean? Like, it ain't easy to be the roadie. You're fucking doing the loadout.
But then it's
a
guarantee.
That's a sound that you'll never know.
But it's like a guarantee that you've got people dancing every show. Because just all you need is just one dude dancing, and you're like, right. Oh, we're dancing? Cool.
Try to fucking do the show if he doesn't fucking put on the goddamn house mics. Everybody's fucked. I think roadies should actually even make a little more because they don't even get to ever take the plane. They're always driving.
Yeah.
The van takes the
we'll
plane.
We'll meet you there. It's going to take us a while.
We're going to go back to the hotel, sleep for 12 hours, get up, have a lovely fucking breakfast, get on our plane, and then meet you guys just as you're arriving after driving all night. You better fucking do it right.
You're gonna be ready for this bed. Do not fuck this up.
You're nothing but a roadie.
You're a fucking roadie, and I'm the lead fucking singer of this band. No one shows up to see the roadies. Now never sleep. and stop wearing a cowboy hat everywhere. And stop stealing my blowjobs. I wonder, like, if you're a roadie for a band that sucks, is it more embarrassing than being a roadie for a band that fucking rocks?
I think absolutely.
Has to be.
Like, each fucking thing does the same amount of work.
Yeah, I know, but I think that they feel like a secondary member of the band. It only works if you love that band. Yeah. Or at least that you think they're cool. Or
wait a minute. Look at this picture somebody sent in of young Chris Stanley. I don't even remember him looking like that.
Let me come over to see this.
What is that? What is that and when is that?
Let me see.
It's on. It's an old RonFez.net picture.
That's weird. Why am I dressed like that? I don't remember that.
Kyle Firestein has put it out. Do a retweet on it. If anybody can remember when Chris used to look that way or why he felt so sexy.
I look pretty sweaty, though.
Sweaty, but slim.
Consistent.
Weren't you digging on Chris Stanley when you first met him?
I doubt it.
Or was that the Irishman?
No, that was the Irishman. That was the Irishman.
Oh, some people are saying Rockahula Luau.
That makes sense. The way that's I'm fucking dressed.
That's your costume?
Must have been.
You must have been dancing your ass off. Because that's in studio. That's not at the Rockahula, and there's no reason for you to be sweating like that.
Why are you so sweaty?
Nothing has to happen for me to sweat.
It looks like you're wearing a Hawaiian shirt, but then it looks like you're wearing some kind of weird fucking unitard underneath it.
What the fuck?
Yeah, like, that does kind of look like a jumpsuit under there.
And do I just have a mustache?
Yeah, you do have just a mustache.
Well, that's when you're an undercover cop in the 70s.
Is this you? Like, I'm starting to doubt it. Like, I don't remember your hair being feathered like that.
He feathered his hair for a while.
For a little while. It was a phase. Looks like I'm in the booth at 57th Street. Throwing a thumbs up. That's pretty cool.
I don't get it. I don't know when this was. I don't ever remember you looking.
Fucking sweat. Christ, what's wrong with my glands?
Oh, no, you sweat worse than that. That fucking a couple shows ago,
yeah.
In the summer, you were just soaked from fucking head to toe.
Yeah,
it was disgusting.
It was scary. You looked severely dehydrated too.
Maybe that's why he's taking such a long fucking dangerous shit every night.
It's fucking dry as bone in there.
Oh. You can end up cracking a tooth on one of those fucking big fucking brick shits of his. All right, they said that you were dude love back in those days.
Dude love.
I think that's when he was producing the Hedberg special and wanted to look like him.
We weren't dressing in costume for this.
Why not?
Hey, the you got a mail guy now drives for Uber in Ohio. You've got mail.
You've got mail. I kind of miss that sound.
That was, well, the thing was, is that guy was doing that when you didn't even get that much mail. Like, you know, your friends weren't even all online yet.
It was barely spam then even.
No, there was no spam.
Yeah.
There was nothing to spam because the websites weren't out there.
Yeah. Everyone just went inside AOL's like fucking.
I thought that was the entire internet.
I know.
I'm like, oh, look at the internet. It's got a sports section. This is great.
Ooh, television.
Wait a minute. There's a Phil's fucking chat room. I can go there and discuss the Phil's. So I like it when they win.
ASL.
That's so fucking strange, right?
Yeah.
And that you got mail guy was probably the most known voice in the country for a while.
You've got mail.
You've got mail. Now remember when they would let celebrities do it?
Oh, yeah, like you could choose.
Yeah, you could choose to suddenly have a different celebrity, like Cher would tell you that you had mail and shit.
I don't want to hear Cher. I want to hear this guy.
Yeah, they did say other things, too, besides you got mail. I can't even remember what they are now.
Yeah,
they
like
would have
he
other
said,
announcements
well, oh,
then.
Welcome. Like when you signed
welcome.
In.
Welcome.
You've got mail.
You're like, do I really?
Huh. It used to be so exciting to get mail. Like an email was exciting. Now it's just like, ugh, God.
Chris, what's he want now?
Just text it to me.
Just fucking write it on a piece of paper and leave it behind. They're saying that a lot of fucking people are voting today.
It's usually half, right? Half the country votes and half doesn't.
Yeah, about that.
That's weird.
But half the country don't vote?
Just half the country's like, nah.
I've skipped elections. Well, a lot of times people skip the
Have you
congressional.
Skipped an election before?
Fuck yeah.
I skipped Obama too.
I really hate this Obama one and two.
He is annoying. And like everything else with him, it'll go away tomorrow.
And I'll never remember Obama two.
I'll never remember the gimmick that he started. All right, let's break here, and we'll send the kid out, and we'll show you what New York City is looking around. Right back, Bennington.
We're going to look at who is even eligible to be a candidate.
I think football coaches should be up there. I honestly think that there's a couple that I would trust. There's one in New England right now, Bill Belichick, who I'm like, I think he would get things done. You know, he would just... He's a guy who prepares. He's a guy who prepares. I, on the other hand, am not a guy who prepares.
No, but you, like, are just prepared. It's like you don't do it beforehand, but you're just like, you're ready to go.
I'm shocked that it doesn't work all the time. I'm like, I didn't prepare. Why isn't this working? I am shocked right now. I thought I could just come in here and magically be good at something. But a lot of people are putting out songs against Dr. Trump, and we've been playing a bunch of them. Who do we got today?
Okay,
this will be the last day for the protest songs.
Well, it started
as 30 for 30.
It started as 30 for 30. I checked yesterday, became 30 for 50. So they've been releasing two or three songs a day.
No, that's too many.
No, we can't listen to 50.
But a couple of our buddies released songs.
All right, who's that?
Mr. Reggie Watts released a song with the Cooties.
That I want to hear.
All right, let's take a listen. This is, what's Reggie Watts' song called?
Trumpy Trump.
Okay. Sounds like
great title.
Yeah. A lot of people complaining about the bumper music ran all through our conversation.
That's odd because I put that room down.
I'm just telling you what they're complaining about.
I will.
It's not still running, is it?
It shouldn't be, no. I'll let engineering know. No, it's not.
Why would engineering have to know? Hey, here, charge me up.
Now, who's that with Reggie Watts? So Reggie's featured on. Oh, the Cooties.
The Cooties.
Trump, Eddie, Trump, Trump, Trump.
I got to check with people. Is there still the Lonely Island running?
No, it's not running.
I know that you're saying it, but I'm telling you what people are telling me. The music is still playing, and that's from 8 seconds ago.
They might be on delay because it's not running right now. I have that room up and nothing's coming out of it.
Stephen Knight says the rejoinder music has been playing over you two talking for 2 minutes. Can't hear you.
I was told when the new studio was put together that if I drop this room... We can't
hear
that.
Is it running now?
It's not running now. No, it's up and there's nothing running now.
How are you sure?
Because if it was running, I'd hear it because I have that room up.
Yeah, it's weird because I didn't hear it in my headphones, though.
Yeah, I dropped it. That's what, because if this thing's down, we can't hear Vito and we shouldn't be able to hear any music coming out of that room. And it was down and off.
Intro music. Just drowned out the last 5 minutes of people talking.
Well, this bed's 2.5, but yeah, it was probably playing. That was my mistake.
Mm. Where's Vito?
I don't know. I told him to come back here. Don't know where he is. I've texted him a couple times to ask him where he's went.
Here's our buddy Connor. Hey, Connor.
Hey.
You're out on the street. By the way, did you send Vito back?
Yeah. Hey, Vito. He just told you to go back.
I told Vito to come back here.
Yeah, he's on his way.
Okay.
Who's running the Pal Talk thing?
That would be Nick at Night. Nick. Is running. Yeah.
Is it up?
Not up yet. So tell Nick to start it.
Nick, start it. We good to go? I think we're good to go here.
All right, let's take a look. And where are you guys exactly?
We are on 49th, and we're right in front of Radio City Music Hall.
Okay, so you're nowhere near it.
Yeah, we're walking to it right now.
Okay, we'll check back in with you guys when you get closer. Thanks. So, what are some of the other videos?
The other is Open Mike Eagle has a song.
All right, nice. Buddy.
How to be super petty to your ex.
Okay. That's how to be super petty to your ex. I don't know what that's got to do with the election at all.
It's very cryptic, but yeah. Open Mike Eagle's cool.
Oh, he's the coolest.
And Tim Heidecker also made someone called Trump's pilot.
Tim Heidecker talking about flying Trump's plane into a field. That was very unexpected.
It took such a dark turn.
Yeah, didn't see it coming.
I thought that fund was because he wasn't well paid.
Yeah, I did not know that it was because Tim was going to fly the plane into an empty field. I didn't see it coming in a post 9/11 world. Did not see it coming that way.
It got dark fast.
Hmm. Hey, Vito, you know when you left the fucking music up and it ran for like 5 straight minutes. The rejoinder music.
What music?
The rejoinder music. You know how we do a rejoinder music? It just ran and ran and ran and we couldn't hear it in this room.
I didn't set that up. I wasn't here when the rejoinder music was set up.
We pulled you back in so you could run that room properly. Can't be run out of both rooms.
Found that out today.
Luckily, we found it out on the air instead of doing some producing stuff off air. We made a guarantee that something could be done some way. Connor, where are you guys at now?
We're at the Hilton.
All right, I'm trying to watch. There's Connor and Nick and Knight together. And what's the feeling? Is it a feeling of patriotism, excitement?
I feel very patriotic right now.
All right, show us, and how are you seeing this, Chris?
This go to the Interrobang's Twitter, at the iBang. At the iBang, it's the first tweet there.
Is it, when you're saying that, so I'm saying, is this Facebook Live?
This is Periscope.
This is Periscope, and you can view it on our Twitter.
I go over there?
Yeah, go over there. What's it look? You got things from all over the world there?
Yeah, we have all kinds of things. I don't know what they are, but they obviously have a truck with cameras, and there are people running around. There's cops everywhere.
Now, are people gathering?
Kind of, yeah. Well, we're walking over to the CBS building, and there's a lot of people gathered over here.
What are they
kind of watching?
Just watching from across the street.
Any chanting?
Yeah. There's a lot of people, I think, doing exactly what we're doing. Yeah, live videoing this.
Yeah, live video. This is the biggest thing you've ever been to in your life, Connor? Just 10 times bigger than the Super Bowl?
I would say this is bigger than the Super Bowl.
Okay, good. That's good to hear.
I would say so. Good. Never been to the Super Bowl, but I would say it's bigger than the Super Bowl.
That's all you got to do. If you say it, I believe it.
I believe him.
Now,
it's pretty big.
Keep walking in that direction and walk over to the Trump Tower. You have to walk past the Regis Hotel, which is on, 50th Street or 51st?
I think it's
Chris?
51st. I'll double check.
Yeah, because for some reason they got the Regis shut down. The St. Regis Hotel, not just the Regis.
Right, not Regis Filament.
Got Trump Tower. All right. So we're, where's that 51st Street, you said?
51st.
Trump Tower is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell him to get night. He looks really good on screen.
He looks
so
great.
You, yeah. He's a very handsome young man.
Ron thinks so.
Yeah.
So I'll show him this thing. Show him what's going on here.
But if you go over and hit our Twitter on the scope there, you can see that, well, New York City is just a buzz today. You know?
Yeah, that is a massive collection of news trucks. There.
From all around the world, from as far away as Missouri to Kalamazoo.
They look like they've been camped out all night. They're like sleeping bags and shit.
Let's not judge them, Connor. You know what I mean? They're just young journalists trying to get some work done.
Some of those just the
Wait,
homeless.
What is that thing in the orange? What's that about?
The orange?
Yeah, it looks like an orange glassy box. Maybe it's just a tree. Look
one.
At that. There's all the journalists you can see.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, my God is right, Chris. Oh, my God.
The journalists.
Looking for...
Trump Tower's on 56th and 5th.
All right, so now you're going to 56th and 5th.
56th and 5th?
Yeah, it's Trump Tower, Connor.
And all right, we'll check back in with you in a little bit.
All right.
So there it is. We're running the entire operations for the Republicans and Democrats. I don't know whether you can still hear me. Vito might have left up the music. I don't know.
I don't know what happened. I was gone before the music was played.
You're trying to rat out your buddy fucking Chris, aren't you?
Chris, what's the truth?
It's not like Chris ever put a picture of you with your face melting down into your neck.
Well, he obviously put the music up and didn't realize that he could have, one, told somebody in the room to pull the music down.
I thought... incorrectly, that if I can bring down this pot, if I bring this pot down, I can't hear Vito. So I was told that shuts down that room.
You know that's not true now.
That is not true. It just shuts down his mic, not the music that comes out of that room. Mm.
But then how do you not hear the music? And we didn't hear it.
Yeah, I don't know. It was weird.
You turned
I didn't
off our room,
my...
not that room.
No, I turned off that room. I pulled it all the way down and then couldn't hear anything. I didn't go back to check. That was my problem.
What I'm saying is we didn't hear
it. Yeah, it didn't come through my headphones.
No.
It just sounded normal.
So, Vito, we had to pull you back in.
I'm missing all the party out there now.
Well, the fact is, you should see this as a party, you know?
We're the party.
And what do the party people say?
Woo.
Mm-hmm. Party people say woo. That's exactly right.
And you guys, I don't want to see you guys fighting on election day, Chris and Vito.
Brother against brother.
It really hurts
Not
me.
So much about the election, but how two fucking producers... undo their jobs.
The only two who are not fighting about the election.
Oh, no. They have no idea there's an election going on.
Mm-mm.
They're just figuring out which one of them can drown out the show as quickly as they can.
I vote against that.
I feel like you guys brought the TV show punked back to everybody.
I don't want the TV show punked to come back.
Why?
I'm sick of all the punking.
Punk has really been replaced by that Staten Island TV show. What are they called?
Impractical Jokers.
They're new wave punk.
I don't believe that they should call themselves impractical. They should be practical jokers.
Let's just be really practical about this. You can't shake this cold.
It's not a cold. It's TB.
No!
Oh, Jesus, no.
No. Don't get upset. TB is just short for tuberculosis.
I know what it's short for. I was well aware. Can we get some face masks in here?
For yourselves?
I'll gladly take the TB.
Seems like every time I cough, some blood comes up.
No, that's not right.
God.
And if that happens in the first act, you know what that means.
Don't worry, it looks like it's pretty rusty.
No, that doesn't make me feel any better about it.
Where are we at? Are you following along?
They're not at... They're by the Hilton again.
Oh my God, they don't know where they're going.
It's a grid.
Yeah, it's a grid. They should be able to figure it out.
These youngsters are
But if
confused.
if you watch along, and we've got it up on Twitter, you'll see what a madhouse it is. Here we are, hours and hours and hours before the polls close. The polls are going to stay open tonight till 3 o'clock in the morning. Red, what's up?
First off, Ron, $1 million.
$1 million to you, Gail, my friend.
Gail, $2.3 million.
Whoa.
Oh, sweet.
That's very sweet.
And Chris Stanley, $1.75 Canadian.
More than half, right?
Deserved.
Okay. So there was a lot of talk before of if Trump wins, that some Americans will be moving to Canada. And I wanted to throw an offer out to Gail.
Mm.
If you want to move to Canada and become my wife, I would even buy you a snow machine and maybe a winter parka.
Wow.
Hold on.
And we have free health care here, too.
I'm beginning to like the sound of this. I love the parka being thrown into the deal. And then a snow machine. Is that cool thing that, like, Scatman drove in The Shining? Like one of those?
I don't know. It's been so long since I've seen The Shining, but I think so.
Well, explain a snow machine.
It's a jet ski, but made for going on snow.
Okay, yeah, that's something different. That's way cooler than Snowcat.
All right, now why?
Oh,
yeah.
I think it's called a bombardier.
Yeah. Why isn't that just called a snowmobile? What you described as the snow machine.
Oh, I don't know. I guess there's different words for them. So maybe it's an area specific thing that.
Let's wait, see if Trump gets elected, and then we'll work out some of the verbiage that we're going over here.
And I will consider your proposal.
Mm. You know, Chris could end up marrying Melanie and living in Toronto.
Oh, my gosh, we'd be neighbors.
If she divorces her husband.
Here's hoping. I mean, I would like that free health care.
Did you think that she was gorgeous?
Yeah, she was
great. She was a knockout.
Yeah. I like her accent, too. It was awesome.
Yeah, it's very, very sexy. Here's what she looked like to me. Like she could have been in the play Hair. You know those sexy, always sexy chicks in that play?
It's a very good look.
Wait, what's this? Colin Quinn's New York Stories coming out?
Yeah, it's coming out next Friday on Netflix, and they released a trailer today.
Are we doing a meeting after the show today, Chris?
No. No, we're not.
But there's so many things I wanted to talk about. Do we have time?
No, we just don't. It's not going to happen.
Dang.
How about if we just get together for a couple minutes?
Nope.
We're busy bees, I guess.
You got to do the show. Break out.
I want to then bite into one of those big Reese's cups.
When Connor calls back, we'll get him to pick one up on his way back. And I'll tell him it's too expensive.
Is it big enough that you can just slice it like a pie?
It's gigantic. It's huge.
I'm in.
No, we're not doing that.
That's Connor, an election treat.
Connor, you're expensive. Six?
No.
Six giant Reese's cups.
No way could any human eat one by himself. That's like eating fucking manhole cup.
Yeah, I thought we were splitting
it. Let's get back on the thing with Con. Oh, we don't have them, do we? Well, let's just put up their thing and see what they're saying.
Oh, God.
What is...
I think that they're not even friends. Like, just thought that they would just be talking to each other.
Do they know about talking when you're walking around like that?
I think it's that might be before their time.
Yeah, I don't think they're very close.
I feel like they should be, though. I mean, it's short blocks.
They're confused. They're so sweet, but they're confused.
Yeah, I know. I like them a lot, though.
They're a couple twinks in New York City.
Look, you can see how shitty, fucking crazy New York is
now. Just a couple of twinks.
Like, if you lived anywhere else in the country, you would look at this and go, what are they doing? This is a lot of times my walk to work. It's fucking dystopian.
Just so many scaffoldings.
A lot of times I'll think to myself walking in here, please don't let that crane fall now.
Oh, I think of it all the time.
Look, see, there's just the ABC 7 for no reason. I don't know what the fuck is going on around there.
I don't know. The twinks are on it, though.
Just a couple. The twinks are getting it. I said our twinks, our twinks.
So we both tried to do a twink parody at the same time.
What was yours?
Just a couple of twinks going to the Hilton.
I tried to look up how to get it, and I just put twinks in it. I don't know what I was thinking.
I hate when somebody says something, and then you just end up writing it.
Yeah, it's really fucked up. I feel like a crazy person when that happens.
Why don't you feel like a crazy person when you leave the fucking Majorna music blasted?
I felt like a crazy person that as well. I feel crazy most of the day. I just try to find some sanity in a 24-hour period.
All right, someone has sent us a picture of a woman. I guess she's supposed to be mooning the Clinton cane plane, but it looks like she's welcoming it into her asshole is kind of what I'm getting from it.
Well, first of all, I appreciate the pose, but I'd like to see it from behind, please.
Yeah. I mean, it kind of, what I'm imagining is happening on the other side of that photo is just full goatee.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, man, goatee. I haven't thought about goatee in a long time.
It's like one of those early internet things you really just missed. Just like the You Got Mail guy.
Yeah. I mean, goatee was everywhere. He was so popular.
I haven't been goateed in a dog's age.
And then there was Tub Girl, which was truly disturbing.
Oh, yeah, that was the major, right?
That one, like, goatee, like, I got used to. Like, I saw it.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I got used
By
to goatee.
By the way, if someone goateed me right now, whatever.
Yeah, but Tub Girl always fucked me up. I was like, oh, God, Tub Girl. What happened to that Asian woman?
All right, we going back to Connor?
Yeah. Connor's back up.
Hey, Connor. Connor, we got you, buddy? All right, now, if you look around, you can see just dump trucks surrounding.
Wow!
Yeah. And that's dump trucks filled
Holy
with sand.
Crap. That is really weird. Turn that a little tiny bit towards me so I can see.
This is pretty wild.
Oh, yeah, that's really weird looking.
This is... He has fortified his castle. It's pretty scary, actually. Where is he? Oh, there's Nick.
Are you
Yeah, this is pretty wild. There's cops everywhere keeping people from getting too close, and there's just a mob of people. This is way worse than the Hilton.
No, it's a very strange thing, and you think to yourself, people live in that building.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And they paid a lot of money. Something like Steven Spielberg has an apartment there. You know he hasn't been in that building in a while. He's like, I don't fucking trust it.
There?
This is insane. It's kind of hard to explain, but there's people just climbing all over people. Yeah. And there's some people... There's some crazy people here.
Okay. You're painting a picture that I just love, Connor. All right, let me see if I can talk to Nick for a second.
All right, yeah, sure.
Yeah. Can you take the camera and put it on him? I want to see
What's
Nick.
What's going on?
Nick, I want you to act like you're like a real reporter for the Bennington News.
All right. Hold on 1 second. We need to show the camera around, all right? Let me call back Connor. Hold on.
All right.
Caleb. Again. Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
We're getting kind of pushed around by police to keep the traffic moving. So we're going to try and just keep circling.
Who are the are people protesting or something, or were there signs?
Yeah, there's people Make America Hate Again. And there's like this guy has a giant plaque that has a Bible verse on it that's basically saying Trump is Satan. From Revelation.
Try to get an interview with that guy.
You want to get an interview with that guy?
Yeah.
All right. We may be moved along by NYPD, but we'll see what's going on. Yeah. We're going to get an interview with that guy.
Let him know freedom of the press. They'll understand.
Are you seeing more protest signs? Oh, you got him?
There we go. Hold on. Sure. Just move over there.
A cop just cut him out.
I have a man who wants me to read some sentences. Do you want to hear this, Bennington? He's handing me cards to read on the air. Do you want me to read it?
Yeah, go ahead and read it.
All right. With regards to the ills of society, nothing changes simply because our experts have still not figured out that the mind and the brain are two separate entities. The fact that brain education and mind education are lumped together are just the single entity of mind education in the case of all the mess of society. We're looking for partners to create emotional health apps. And this is Sajid Khan. He's Wisdom Springs Effortlessly from Emotional Health. So we're here with Sajid Khan. How you doing? You're protesting Trump? Yes.
So what I did was I did a leadership test of Mr. Trump.
Yes.
Throw that up there, man. Keep that up there. Let the world see.
So Mr. Trump's mind is brilliant, and that is why he's done a lot of good stuff His mind is perfectly normal, super normal, needs to do a lot of the stuff that he'll be doing, but his brain is emotionally challenged.
His mind is fine.
You need the brain, because the mind you have to hire anyway, because you can't be an expert of everything. But when it comes to leadership, the brain has to be emotionally healthy. His brain is emotionally messed up. It is emotionally challenged, and it's not even fit to be a mayor of a small village. And that's why I'm trying to tell the people to realize that even though his mind is good, his brain is bad, and the brain is the bottom line.
So he has a mind, but he doesn't have a brain?
No, brain is totally messed up.
Right.
Yeah, his brain needs 10 years of emotional therapy. Here, you can see that's the banner right there. See that one?
I see that one, yeah.
Yeah, that's the one.
Hey,
one.
Hey, Connor.
He needs to train his brain for 10.
Hey, Connor.
Yeah, Ron.
Could you ask the protester there that for Mr. Trump, that ask him that with the thoughts that he's thinking, could he be another Lincoln if he only had a brain?
If the thoughts that he's thinking, could he be another Lincoln if he only had a brain? No. He doesn't agree.
His game is like a defective voter. You see, he is like the president of the world, president of America, is the engine. And if the machine of the engine is messed up, where will it go? It will stop 10 places, create lots of problems. He's not fit.
Is there anyone that could give him like a brain or help him out, like some type of wizard?
I went from the AK to one of my organizations I'm part of, No Labels, which is doing a great job. We are trying to tell the world that instead of the two parties or three parties fighting, why don't they all work together for the common good of men? So he came there, and I told him, I said, look, your problem is you have the best mind, but your brain is messed up, and I can help you. He said to me, I'm very busy, but I'll take your details, and I'll get back to you when I can.
So if you don't call me, I'll call you, kind of thing?
Exactly.
Connor.
Thank you for talking to us.
Connor, ask him one more question from us.
We have another question. What's the question?
Yeah. Ask if he could while away the hours conferring with the flowers and consulting with the rain.
So, like, would you ever ask Trump, or like, would you consider walling in the flowers to get away the hours to wallow in the rain? And like that, would the brain help with that? You don't understand what I'm saying? No, it's all in my mind and brain.
All right.
I've been working for the last 1 year.
Good job,
Shatter. My mind is gone.
Bring him down. That's some good stuff he's getting out there. So this is why the NYPD stays so busy.
Yeah.
And this isn't Trump's fault, but this is the kind of shit that this brings in.
Yes. It has brought out a lot of emotion, strong opinions on both brains and minds.
Now, do you get what he's getting from the mind and brain thing?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like he's intelligent, but his emotions are what's the problem, is what that gentleman was saying.
Do you feel like he could be talking about you right now, Chris?
Oh, my God.
Because you're smart as shit.
So,
thank you. Well,
but your emotions are dumb as dirt.
Oh, my emotions just control my life.
You think he's smart?
Well, I thought it was really smart that I thought it was really smart the way that he left that music on. For 5 minutes. I hope that didn't bother
you. Well, you know what I did think was smart is when he tried to pin it on Theo.
And then tried to make us forget all about it by buying 6 giant fucking Reese's cups. The size.
Cups are good. Reese's cups are good.
He thought 40 pounds of Reese's cups would make us forget what happened.
And you know what? He's probably right.
Yeah.
I don't even remember what we were upset about.
All right, tell the kids to come on back. They did a bang-up job.
They did a great job.
Bang-up job.
Call the Twinks back.
Twinks.
Connor actually might have to go to his other
room. Okay, we'll let him go wherever he wants to go.
Yeah, he's right, free.
You want me to go in here with him? Connor, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
You did a bang-up job, both of you guys, and we're going to cut you loose now. But really
all right,
nice
sounds
job.
Good.
Great right. interview.
Great job.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, bye. Talk to you later. All right, so that's our own Twink news for us. They're out there. just seriously knocking the stuff into the competition.
Oh, they really are. Just
I mean, you've heard a story here that you wouldn't hear anywhere else about Donald Trump. That's the fact that his mind is great. His mind's filled with leadership. His brain, on the other hand, not so good.
No.
Kind of shabby.
Too many emotions.
That's the first time we broke off the thing in a long time.
Yeah. Well, I'll be on Periscope tonight. It looks like Trump Tower is the place to be as opposed to the Hilton, but it might change
Trump
by
tonight. Tower is a place to be.
Trump living is a life for me.
Trump Bear! I kind of feel like Times Square could blow up tonight, too.
You think?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think it could turn into 1945 VJ Day, you know? It's kissing like nurses in the fucking in the square.
Hell yeah. I'll be all over the place. I'll just be doing a walking tour.
Oh, you'd actually kiss the nurse in Times Square?
Would you kiss the nurse?
People forget. He could, because we have male nurses now, unlike 1945.
What? One in Rome, right, guys?
That's not Rome. That's fucking that's where your own neighborhood. You could get one of those comfortable with yourself Tim Dillon lifestyles.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you'd be so much more likable that way, I think.
Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah.
Really?
Yeah, lose some of this hateable edge that you have.
Didn't realize it was so hateable.
So you're still blaming Vito for that fucking problem?
Yeah, I'm blaming Vito for that 100%.
And Vito took zero responsibility for it.
No, I was gone before the music was even touched.
You know, we saw pictures of you sleeping with your face down in your neck.
I think
we know you're not a hard worker.
Sleeping in that booth. To be totally honest,
I'm glad that you're telling me.
Really?
I think he was snoozing.
He's just an asshole, and he knows he could get away with blaming me for shit because there's a sleeping video of me out there.
He can get away with you for that because anytime, like, I'll go, well, Vito's a good guy. He'll show me. He showed me last night before I went on stage. He's going to look at this fucking video.
Don't forget this.
I went to the trailer. Yeah. I was like, hey, Rod, I know you got the show coming up, but just watch this one more time.
Oh, I forgot you came into the trailer and started talking really loud.
Did I?
Yeah, well, you know what was funny about our trailer? It was the movie star trailer, and it's right on the street.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how when you walk, like, you're like, hey, those movie star trailers, I wonder what they're doing in there. I can tell you right now, nothing.
Mm-mm. Just hanging out.
I heard Lisa Traeg ask for a whiskey. I was like, is there whiskey in here?
No, but there was a lot of sodas.
I saw a lot of beers when she opened up the fridge.
Yeah, a lot of cold beers.
And snacks. A lot of snacks, like cookies,
yeah, but the
pretzels.
Snacks weren't so good. There was a thing that somebody could eat Cheetos before they went on stage. And I'm like, who would want to do that?
Sucking your fingers.
Yeah, like, some orange dust around your lips.
Cheetos is not I got a couple minutes. Let's eat that. Cheetos is like I'm at my house by myself.
Right.
Or I'm taking a long drive.
Now, here's what I found out the hard way.
I will eat. You know how like they have like the snack mix?
Yeah.
And Cheetos are part of that mix?
Yeah.
I was like, I've had them in there recently out of the vending machine. I was starving the other day. The vending machine was completely empty except for a couple shitty things. At this age, I no longer can eat a bag of Cheetos. Like, it just doesn't feel right. It feels really weird.
Can I give you another one? Could you eat Cheese Puffs? They're lighter. Much lighter.
Texture is great on the puff.
I like to eat a cheese puff.
Then if you don't like the oranges, though?
Yeah, I'm like okay with it. I just think like eventually you tire of it in a way that you did not tire that way when you were younger.
Well, first of all, I would have been able to eat an entire bag of cheese puffs when I was little. But why don't you have pirate booty? We had some of that last night.
Oh, love pirate booty.
It's a tasteless fucking
cheese puff. Like a tasteless adult cheese puff.
Right.
All right. Cheeto versus puff versus cheese ball.
Not even close for me.
Puff.
Straight puff, though.
Cheeto?
I don't know. I like the texture of a Cheeto.
Do you like the texture leaving the fucking music on while you walk down the street?
That's the texture this motherfucker loves. 100%
on Chris Stanley. That
so
wasn't
you're
on
saying
me.
It's puff and stuff?
I'm going to tell you right now. I'll put balls as number two, and Cheetos, I don't even want one. I do not want a fucking Cheetos.
I think balls might be number one for me.
Bullshit.
Please don't isolate that.
Fucking pull that.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you over Vito's music.
Vito, why are you still playing music?
He changed it to Donkey Shade.
It's not rejoinder music.
I was Vito.
Why can't you be the next Chris Stanley instead of the next Vito?
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like all my mistakes are making me the next Chris Stanley.
Bullshit.
See?
You never catch me
sleeping. He hurt both of you with that.
More snack, questions, please.
More snack-related questions?
Yeah, please do.
What is the best part of a trail mix?
All right, that is a good one. The small piece of chocolate that doesn't belong there. That keeps it from being a healthy fucking snack and turns it into a tasty treat.
I like a salty nut.
Isolate that.
What are the chip things in those?
Like, oh, that's Rejoiter music.
Oh, they're delicious.
My answer is raisins because I'm a grandma.
No, I don't like raisins at all.
I like raisins. I like raisin bran.
It's a fucking rotted grape.
I love a raisin, and I can't believe how polarizing they are. I just don't understand it.
I will say, well, you know what? I'm going to agree there. Raisin bread, because it's like it turns your toast into a little bit of. Only way I could eat it is with toast. But it turns it into like a little dessert.
It's fun.
Yeah. You know, oatmeal raisin is my preferred cookie. Raisin.
I'm going to move over my preferred cookie. And we got some great ones that were brought to us this at the last gig that we did.
Yeah.
Those were fantastic. But
by Maureen.
Yes.
Of course. That's what we're talking about.
But a sugar cookie is something an adult can sit down and enjoy for themselves.
Oh, yeah. I like a cookie with a tea. Yeah. I also like a butter cookie for the same reason.
Oh, hell yeah.
All right, I'm going to switch from sugar cookie over to a butter cookie.
Oh, my God, do I love a butter cookie.
Now, Vito, let me just point this out to you. The only problem I have with the Italian cuisine is their cookies and desserts.
Oh, I love an Italian cookie.
It is also a thing that you have to be Italian to love an Italian cookie. I think it
might be. You don't like rainbow cookies?
Hell no.
Well, you don't like all the... You don't like
I don't
all the
anisette
like,
and all that
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, like the anisette.
What is that doing in a cookie?
That licorice-y kind of flavor.
No. What about the one that's like two cookies with jelly in between dipped in chocolate?
Love.
Disgust.
Go either way.
I'd rather have a fucking Oreo any day of the week. And that is no fucking lie. America beats the shit out of...
What about a pizzelle?
Ugh.
What is a pizzelle?
Come on. You know what that is. They're like the very... thin, kind of almost waffly shaped and textured.
People make them around
yeah, it's typical.
Christmas.
Yeah, they suck.
No, they don't.
They're tasteless.
They don't.
They put powdered sugar on them.
Yeah, powdered sugar. Sugar and a little, I think a little.
All right, stop it with saying everything sucks.
And also,
no way powdered sugar
and also
sucks.
Come on, fatty, you know you don't think powdered sugar sucks. It's sugar in powder form. Everyone fucking likes it.
Yeah, no one has a problem with powdered sugar. But I'm not the biggest pizzelle fan. That goes without saying.
There's not enough to it. They're too thin.
All right, let's go this. And I'm going to fucking go across the board with some of these.
Okay.
All right, let's try this one. Best pretzel shape. The rod, the twist, the original, with the little sticks.
God, man, I love the little sticks. But I don't remember the last time I bought them.
I'm going to go straight original gangsta every time.
Twist.
No, like the classic shape.
Yeah, classic pretzel shape.
I'm going to go twist, like the long twisted pretzel.
Those are the worst.
You're a dick.
Stop it, Vito.
You got
it. It's bad enough you left the music on all day.
Thank you, Ron.
You two are hard on that little boy.
The, some people call the twist braids. I don't. But I'm going to say the original is the tastiest. It's made that way for a reason. And I like a pretzel with a chip. Don't offer me pretzels or chips. I'll put them together and make it into a little sandwich. All right. I'm going to give you another quick one.
All right. Let's go.
The jelly bean. Delicious or stupid? Disgust.
It's a stupid shit show. I hate it.
I love them.
I hate
them. I find them to be really fun.
The Harry Potter ones are exciting.
Because they come in different tastes?
Yeah, like disgusting ones and good ones.
Well, you should have been with me last night. I met Draco Malfoy down in the village. Hey, do you know where you guys are fucking around at that show last night?
What?
Madonna was doing a live concert free.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, I heard that. Like, just like a couple blocks down, Madonna did a free show at the same time.
She just tweeted out, hey, I'm in the park, ready to party. And she did some songs.
Like a virgin? Did you do like a virgin?
Yeah, she did. She did it twice, as a matter of fact. Oh, people are going fucking crazy. Swedish fish, a gummy bar, or a Sour Patch Kid?
Oh,
Swedish fish, gummy bar, or Sour Patch Kid?
All right. It's really tough between Sour Patch Kids and gummy bears. It must be Haribo gummy bears. But I ate a 4-pound bag of gummy bears once.
Imagine so what that did to your
first
colon.
Of all, I just feel like the way he's doing that, I'm partying with a lumberjack or some like, manly man.
Now I'm just like all those like impacted gummy bears.
I know, just filling up his
that's
fucking,
your problem.
It's gotta be those German Haribos though. They're fucking delicious.
And let me say them.
They like sell them in bodegas a lot, like big bags of them.
And you just buy 4-pound bags and throw them down?
I bought it. Must have been a super 3-pound bag. Excuse me. It was a Target.
I'm going Swedish fish.
No, it fucks your teeth up.
I love them.
I like it sweet, so Sour Patch.
So if you like it sweet, you wouldn't have a Sour Patch, you well, fucking moron.
The Sour Patch is like dipped in sugar.
Yeah, but it's sour, you it's dumb like- fuck. You know, no one calls anything that's sour sweet. That's the exact opposite.
Isn't sour just an overload of sweetness?
Oh my god!
No, you dummy.
You know, I've been trying to help bitterness. You all day, and now you're out on your
Jump
own.
Jump in.
All right. Look, I'm glad this came up because this fucking prick was annoying us in the village last night.
Oh god!
He points to a 5-story building and claims that the top part is the penthouse. He goes, I wish I lived up there in the penthouse. We're like, that's not a fucking penthouse.
It's just
it was a separate area on top of a building. It was a penthouse. Like there was an apartment and then there was a house on top.
Just the top floor doesn't make it a penthouse.
But it was a separate kind of setup from the rest of the building.
Well, guess what? A lot of things, a fucking shed could be a separate thing. Doesn't make it a penthouse.
That makes it even worse. It's an extension to an already fucking there building. So,
dude, I see in the city sometimes it looks like they build a house on top of a building.
Yeah.
And that's what they call a shit shack. And I ain't interested in being there.
And there was an air conditioner sticking out of one of the windows. No fucking penthouse in the world has that. They got central air in a penthouse. Right.
The way that fucking Vito thinks, me and my brother used to share a penthouse together in our house instead of living in the attic. Which, by the way, my mom said, it wasn't an attic because we fixed it up. I go, really? Did you fix it up with heat or air conditioning? Because we had neither. In the winter in Philly, I had to fucking sleep in a sleeping bag like I was in the Marine Corps fucking stationed in Germany. But you know what the funny thing about
that
it is?
It doesn't sound so fixed up.
I got news. No, it wasn't all that fixed up. I mean, it was fixed up. They put beds in there.
Right?
They swept up. Yeah. I mean.
But I'll tell you this. I would have preferred the fucking freezing cold to the fucking heat of the summer. Try being in a fucking attic. When
heat rises.
A fixed up room.
Your penthouse. Your penthouse suite.
Do you have a private elevator to that?
Well, we did have a private staircase. We did have a private staircase. But you know what's good about like living up the stairs from your parents? They'd rather just yell up the stairs than fucking come up there. You know what I mean?
That works.
Yeah, it was a beauty.
Man, I didn't realize I lived in 2 penthouses then. One on a 4-story walk-up, one on a 5-story walk-up.
You're in the penthouse, according to this fucking creep.
Nice.
Look, if it's above a building, it's a penthouse.
That's just wrong.
That's bullshit.
That's just wrong.
I don't think that's true.
Consider yourself you lived in 2 penthouses, you lucky girl.
Let's get a...
That's like, fucking creepy. You don't even call HR on him.
Why? Because he called me lucky girl?
Can I tell you something? Sweet. This fucking guy can't even hear him over the music he's trying to blare.
That was Chris. It really wasn't me. I don't want to take
Dude,
the blame for this.
You got the blame for it.
Look,
and
music
stop.
Man.
Can I tell you something? Stop pointing your finger at Christopher. That kid's a fucking saint.
Thank you, Ron.
Vito, you make it really hard to defend you after that sweet and sour mix-up.
Yeah. It's going.
He just thinks sour is extra sweet.
It's an excessive.
He's no, trying to annoy.
That doesn't.
He's
make,
trying to annoy.
He does try to do that.
No, I don't.
What a jerk, right, guys?
Yeah, you're right again, Chris.
Thank you.
Mm.
First the Cubs, now this.
But why would it even come up that he was saying that was a penthouse last night?
He
just wanted to live there.
Yeah, he was like, "Oh, I wish I lived up in that penthouse up there." I'm like, "That's not a fucking penthouse."
I was just noticing it was a really nice setup up there. They had some nice Christmas lights out.
It wasn't nice. It wasn't like a nice building.
I'm going to give you guys another question.
Let's go.
The graham cracker.
Mm-hmm.
Cracker or a cookie? Discuss.
Cookie.
Cookie. It's cookie.
Cookie. Cookie.
Great radio, Chris.
Cookie.
Cookie. Cookie.
Say cookie.
Cookie.
I think I would call it a sweet cracker, a lightly sweet cracker.
It's a cookie.
First of all, this is the problem. There is no such thing as a sweet cracker. Once it's a sweet cracker, it becomes a cookie.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, the driest cookie that's ever existed?
Yes. There are dry cookies. Look at your fucking Italian cookies. Or as you would call them, a bag of crackers for after the meal.
I wouldn't.
That tastes like Anisette.
Oh.
You're twisting my logic around.
But you know where I'm going with this, right?
Yeah.
A graham cracker fucking tastes like a cookie to me.
Particularly
the ones that even have chocolate on them.
It's a cookie, man. Like, you're not going to... Graham crackers are s'mores, right?
Right?
Yes.
You're not putting fucking saltines on them shits. All right?
No, them shits. Anyone who says them shits.
Look, don't let them shits fucking disarray you away. He came up with something really true. Imagine if you use a fucking saltine and said, kids, we're having s'mores. The kids would fucking riot.
Child services would come.
It's a sweet cracker. Why? Because you put things on it. You slather things on it. You don't do that with a cookie.
No, I eat a graham cracker straight up, plain. I like bland food.
You do like bland food, don't you?
I do. Can't get enough of it.
Well, that's clear.
He likes his blandies.
That and a nice 4-pound bag of Haribo gummy bears.
Hold on, Mark in Iowa wants to tell us something. Go ahead, Mark.
Hey, Bennington. Hey. I just want to say, even us unsophisticates out of here in Iowa know the difference between the top floor and a penthouse. Idiot.
It doesn't seem like it.
There is. There's got to be luxury features to it. And let's face it, to be a penthouse, to me, it's got to be a high-rise building. You know what I mean?
It can't just be the second floor penthouse.
No.
It was higher than the building next to it.
No, it wasn't, actually. The other building was hot, was like fucking 19 stories high.
He added a teen. 19. Look, okay, buddy?
He's caught in a web of
don't
his own lies.
Don't fuck you up with them shits.
I say that you like to line up fucking shoulder to shoulder with Vito against Christopher.
This is really fucked up.
I like what he said about the fucking graham cracker, and I agree with him quite a bit. And I don't agree with anything that fucking Vito has said about any goddamn thing.
How'd you even hear it over the music?
You're a monster.
I didn't hit play on that fucking thing.
Yes, you did. I was gone from
the... He's so confident, even though he's wrong.
At the Thanksgiving show, I was planning to give out a Producer of the Year award.
Oh!
But why not just hand it to Christopher right now?
Please.
Because the fucking Music Man is in town.
He's lying scum.
I've never lied ever.
You're lying right now to everybody.
Dude, what is he lying about?
I was gone. I was down.
You're responsible for that fucking room. We had to yank you off of it.
Well, yeah. There was a day
I
when
you were pouring yourself a Coke over there. It sounded so delicious.
Well, I'll send one of the Twigs to get you a Coke. You want a Coke?
No, that's okay. That's the last thing I need. Hey, are we going to have a meeting after the show today?
No, we can't.
But what about Thanksgiving?
We can't have the meeting.
Okay.
It's not going to happen. There's too much going on.
All right, dude. I'm just saying.
You're firm with him.
What is next week Monday? Is this party on Monday or Tuesday?
Monday.
Monday evening, wow. 7 p.m. at the Hard Rock Cafe.
7 p.m.
7
p.m. Early.
It'll be very dark, though.
You think that's the only way I get my stuff?
That's what I do.
By the way,
it's
last
dark,
night.
It's night.
We were standing on the street. It was 10 o'clock at night. It felt like it was 3 in the morning.
I know. It's like really fucking me up.
No, just relax.
Like you're hammered drunk? Like
keep
that.
It together.
I can't.
It's just fucking, it happens every year.
I don't like it.
Live
it
with it.
It depresses the shit out of me to like look out the window at 4:30 and see the sun setting.
Then just get up an hour earlier in the day. That's all you got to do.
I'm trying.
Get up early. So sleepy. Get out early.
Baby sheepy.
I don't even notice what the weather is outside. You'd have to fucking
frightful.
Tell me. Yeah. You'd have to come in and tell me. Say, you know it's raining? I'd be like, no. Had no fucking idea.
Bullshit.
There could be a blizzard for 4 days. I wouldn't even know. John. John, what's up?
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. A great election show.
Yeah.
Chris Stanley, this question is for you. Okay. As a centaur, yes. What would you prefer, an apple or a sugar cube? Thank you, everyone. You have a great one.
All I know is he likes to have his nose padded when you give it a
yeah.
to him.
Yeah, but make sure your hand is flat while you feed it to him, because he'll nip you. He won't even mean to do it.
No. Jessica, see, look, he hasn't even answered. He's so thrown from that. When the centaur thing comes up, it's a shock.
Every time.
They're not still calling it a centaur, are they?
A lot of it's centaur.
Jessica.
Related, so.
So I've done smart football teams before.
Yeah.
And the only negative is that they're so small, it's hard to fit it all on there. But it's just as good because it gives you the crunch and you get a little salt.
So you don't cook the saltine, right? It's you take
yeah, just like the sandwich part.
Okay, I find it hard to believe.
Give it a try.
Yeah, I find it hard to believe. maybe you know what? I can't argue with you. The Cubs just won it all. You know, there's no talking to you people now. By you people, I mean the whites. Patrick in New York.
Hey guys, what's going on?
You know, trying to get through this election.
I gotcha. Gail, I agree with you. Graham cracker is a cracker. You put butter on it, you put it in s'mores, it doesn't stand alone. So I'm with you on it being a cracker.
What lunatic puts butter on a graham cracker?
I'm going to start because it sounds good.
I eat them raw.
It actually is. When I was
you raw dog it?
I think, look, let the man speak. I'll tell you something.
Yeah.
I don't find a difference in taste between a graham cracker and an animal cookie. You know, those animal crackers, they taste exactly the same to me.
Animal cracker.
No.
Yeah, but that's a cookie, and you fucking know.
Ron, you...
How could a cookie be, one, that tiny, and two, animal shaped? That's cracker status I've ever heard.
If I said, give me some animal crackers, my mom says, you're not eating a cookie this fucking close.
Rod.
Yeah.
I need to defend the Italians, too. At least there's one decent cookie, which is the pinoli cookie. It's delicious. It's got the pine nuts on top of it. The chips are like $19 a pound.
I understand all that, but is it as good as any fucking chocolate chip or any American cookie? The sweet answer is no, my friend. No.
It's like a Christmas decoration.
They are. They come out at Christmas.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, a cookie like that, you eat one and it's too rich because you're eating all that fucking, you know, that nut on it.
Too much nut for me.
Look, let's go back to the fucking animal fucking cracker thing, as you call it, animal cracker. Suppose you just had some cheese, right?
Okay.
You look in. Oh, I don't have any fucking crackers here. Would you like some animal crackers? People are like, I'm not eating a fucking cookie and cheese together.
But what I'm saying is we can live in a world where we have sweet crackers.
What world is
it
that?
It identifies as a cracker. It might be sweet.
A sweet cracker is a cookie, period.
If you took a saltine and took all the salt off and put sugar instead, it'd be a cookie.
No, that sounds like a sweet cracker. Yeah. And even Ron Bennington will. I can see the lack of confidence in that statement.
I don't. I want that stricken from.
Jump out of that.
I want that stricken. First of all, no one has ever scratched off the salt and then rolled it in sugar.
You don't have to dump out. Just play the rejoinder music over it.
God damn it, Vito.
Vito.
And now you're on the fucking phone the whole time.
He's sexting.
We need to take a break.
Then I am. Bennington.
Natalie and Stephanie Negroni are in studio. Natalie.
Hey, guys.
Good to see you.
For Big Brother 18, the Jadley Cruise with Natalie and James from Big Brother and Carnival Cruise Lines set sail Sunday, April 2nd and returns Sunday, April 9th. Portions of the proceeds from the event will go towards the Bullies Reality Foundation.
Yeah. Well, it's great to see you.
Thanks for having me.
It's so fun to have you here.
You know, we're all Big Brother fans here. I personally think It is the most difficult out of all the shows to play and try to figure out. From a strategy standpoint, I find the show to be endlessly fascinating.
I agree with you.
How did you like your game?
Honestly, I loved my game. In the beginning, I was just observing. I played the ditzy and flirty card. Mm-hmm. You know, I was like, I'm going to come in and flirt and be super ditzy. I didn't want people to really see that I'm kind of intelligent. I mean, I don't do math, but I was laying low in the beginning. Yeah. I wasn't a gamer. I didn't know the game that well. So I was, you know, I got recruited for this. So I was like, you know, I got to learn. And I learned throughout the season and I really kicked butt. Like, I flipped the house to get Zaki out. I helped to get Polly out. And I was really proud of my game moves. Like, I really, you know, stood my ground and started making big game moves. So, I mean,
when you're in there, though, does it get to you? I mean, is it nuttier than we could even imagine?
A million percent. Yes. Yeah. I'm not going to lie. This is the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. It really challenges you in every way possible, physically, mentally, emotionally. It's very, very difficult. Now, of course, I would assume that, you know, being just in that house all summer long would be really intense. But I heard something that I don't know why this freaked me out more than anything else, is that you are not allowed to have a pen or paper the entire time you're there. Oh, I don't know why, but that fact really freaked me out.
It's all memory. I mean, this is a game, and you're in it to win it, to win $500,000. So, I mean, a lot of the competitions are memory, too. So, I mean, if you have a pen, I mean, anyone can study any day.
Plus, they could write notes to each other instead of hearing us talk.
But yep, I just realized how many times a day, even just to, like, for stress, do you like pick up a pen and doodle or make a note because you want to? I'm like a big note taker. Like, I make lists of things I need to do. It would really freak me out.
Yeah, Nat writes her calendar out. She doesn't even use her phone. She writes it down.
What was it like for you seeing your sister in this weird glass prison all summer long?
I mean, I wish I could have just reached in the little glass square and, like, hugged her, but,
right,
you know, and sometimes when she felt stressed, I couldn't sleep.
She lost a lot of sleep.
I lost sleep, and I was, like, anxious and all this stuff, but...
Were you watching the feeds the whole time?
I tried to not watch them as much. It was... Because I saw people, like, saying some things, I'm just like, oh, no.
Well, people are going to say stuff about anybody who's in the game, but I also think that the women take it a little tougher... Because a lot of times they're harder on the women for being in show manses, mm-hmm, or for the women for, like, laying low. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, they get a lot of.
But that's because, you know, the internet is the internet. Everybody puts up with it.
Yep.
You wouldn't want to read Trump or Hillary's internet today. They're like, Jesus Christ.
So what's happening today? I forgot. I heard there's like a big election or something.
But so the stress of the game is tremendous.
Oh, 100%. Yeah.
And you wake up in the middle of the night and you realize that you're on a TV set. You wake up in the morning, you realize you're on a TV set.
I honestly, to be honest with you, I never once thought I was on TV the whole time I was on.
Really?
Never. Because you don't have human interaction. So you just see cameras here and there, but you're just like, you're living there 24 hours a day, every day. I made it in the house 86 days. So it's my natural habitat. You know, you really can't fake something else that you're not. Like, your true colors come out and you're there every single day.
How long do you think it took for you to adjust to it, though? That you were just like, this is what life is like now. I live in this house. I can't talk to anybody.
I adapt to new circumstances. I mean, I've moved so much my whole life that, I mean, I lived in Venezuela and Florida and Boston. I've lived all over the place. So I feel like it was just, I adapted very quickly. For me, it was easy to adapt, even though it was like a really difficult situation to be in.
Just the inability to scratch your butt without everybody knowing.
You do not even know the stresses, like even changing.
Sure.
Like, I have a meme on my Instagram that's hilarious. It's me with a towel, with a bra, something on my head. Like, I look like a hot mess. I have pimple cream all over. Like, America gets you at your worst.
Right. They really do. But you would play again if they asked you for All-Stars?
A million percent. I really fell in love with the game. Like, mm-hmm, I so fell in love with it, and I learned it, the ins and outs of it, and I started making big game moves, and I wish I would have lasted in the house a little longer. I mean, I won an HOH, you know? Mm-hmm. So I had a little bucket list I would set in the house for myself to accomplish, and I would meet all those goals. So definitely, I'd be ready to kick some butt.
Now, would you have played the same game, or would you have hooked up with James, or would you have...
If somebody else,
no. Let's suppose if you had that game to play over,
mm-hmm,
did you think using James as your partner was the smartest move, or would it have been easier to be a single?
Honestly, I would have played the game all over again the same way.
Yeah.
James did teach me a lot in the beginning about the game, and I was able to use all the information he taught me and, you know, play my own game in the end. I would do it all over again the same way. But moving forward, going into a new season, I would definitely have a new strategy. Obviously, no showmances, but right. I would come in with a new strategy moving forward.
I think the thing is, you never know what strategy is going to work. Mm-hmm. It changes season by season.
And it's then the chemistry of the house.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And it changes week by week. One person's out, and suddenly the house changes mm-hmm. 1,000,000%.
What was it?
I agree.
What was most shocking to you? Like, what did you go into it going, okay, I think I'm gonna approach it like this, but realizing it didn't work for you?
Mm. In the house, like, the most shocking, yeah. you say? Honestly, everything was really shocking. Do you want, like, more, like, strategy-wise or
yeah.
personal-wise?
Yeah, strategy-wise.
Honestly, I'm very loud. I'm very peppy. I'm very girly. I felt like sometimes my personality really did make me a target. So mm-hmm. that was, like, one of the hardest moments, and I had to balance that out.
Right.
So that was one of the most difficult situations.
Now, would that make you a target more with the other females or the other males?
The females. Yeah. So not only are you in this house, and I came in with a ripped six-pack, like I would work out, you kind of have to stop everything you're doing. You have to analyze the house, analyze your surroundings, and realize how people are around you and how they're perceiving you. Like, I stopped working out in the game. I gained 15 pounds. So you kind of have to really, like, play your cards right and adapt to your new surroundings.
It's just because it's like when you go to a new school and you find out these aren't the cool sneakers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I thought these were the great sneakers. Now they're not.
Everyone told me they're not.
Yeah. I was like, okay, I need to stop working out. I need to not be a threat. Every little thing you have to analyze. Like, even my cooking was making me a threat. So I stopped cooking in the house. You know, I was like, all right, I gotta, you have to tone down who you really are at times.
I think the fascinating thing is for the family, too, at home. We only see about once or twice the show. But I don't think I'd be able to stand to see people mad at Gail, or you know what I mean?
Like, that would drive me nuts.
That would drive me nuts.
Or I'm sure that you had moments where you're like, don't trust this person because you're seeing all the behind the scenes stuff.
There are moments from all angles. Like, for example, you know, when people would bad talk Natalie out of the house and, you know, them not knowing who she is.
Yeah.
I, you know, many times I wanted to call them out, but that's not the thing to do. They probably don't know who she is, and I don't know who they are, and it's just not very civilized.
What about people in the house that you think, oh, I can't stand them?
Yeah.
Was there one? Was there two?
I mean, there was a few, but, you know, peace, love, and happiness, right? Right.
Who for you?
I couldn't stand Pauly. I could not stand
him. But let me say something. Do you think Pauly cracked in there a little bit? I mean, Pauly seemed like he was cracking up to me.
Can I tell you something? Yeah. That house brings out your inner demons. It brings out the worst in you.
Sure.
I'm going to defend everyone in the house because at the end of the day, like, even I had, you know, breakdowns and cried. The kid, I'm sure, broke down in the house. Like, it's a very difficult situation to be in. You don't have your support system, your family. You're locked in this house for all these days without your support system. Like, of course, you're going to lose yourself a little, you know?
I definitely would. I mean, to me, I've been on car trips with people that by the time we get to Miami, I'm like, I'm going to stab you in the neck. And I fucking, you know what I mean? And these are my best friends. Yeah. I drove from New York to San Francisco with a friend of mine.
Yeah.
I thought I was going to kill him.
Well, once he got to that like butterfly moment with James.
Oh, that was insane.
That was like, I was actually concerned. Yeah. I was actually concerned.
And then later he's like, look, I was just playing that for the house. I'm like, I saw you crying like, when it was just
you're
you.
You're not that good of an actor, dude. Like, that was the real
if
you.
So, give him an Oscar already.
But why is he crying in the confessional? There's nobody there that you're playing game with. You're losing it.
He's working the producers.
What was it specifically about that butterfly? He was like, it's a spirit. Oh, I don't know.
He was out of his mind.
He was really cracked at that moment.
See, I didn't get to watch that, so I guess
you
I'm pretty fortunate
it.
On that end, you know?
You never went back and watched the season?
I've watched two episodes.
And said, I can't do this.
I can't relive this.
I'm honestly not ready to watch it yet. I can't wait to watch it, but I've been really busy traveling a lot. So, you know, I'm going to watch it later on.
Chris, it says you went for a nice plug there.
Natalie Negroni's in the studio from Big Brother 18. The Jadley Cruise with Natalie and James from Big Brother and Carnival Cruise Lines set sail Sunday, April 2nd, and returns on Sunday, April 9th. Portions of the proceeds from the event will go towards the Bullies Reality Foundation.
Now, James was your ride or die guy, and you guys are working together outside, mm-hmm. doing stuff like that. How much fun is that? And does he remember the game the same way that that you do.
It is so much fun. Honestly, I have more fun with him outside of the house because there's no cameras.
Right.
And I can actually cuss sometimes and be myself a little more and be super crazy and no one's judging me.
Yeah.
So I love it. And we're having a good time.
Yeah. He's a good guy, huh?
He's a great guy. Honestly, the nicest guy, nicest human I've ever met in my life.
He came very, very close to at least final two. I kind of felt...
I know. Yeah. My heart was broken. Like, yeah. When I saw him on that stage and he made it to final three, but he didn't make it to final two, I was just like, my heart just dropped for him.
Now, do you think he would have won had he been in final two?
To be honest, I do think he would have won. A lot of people are naysayers and they say he wouldn't have won, but... People say this game isn't played personal. People play this game personal. There's no way of getting around it. And I feel like people would have played personal with him. He has a daughter. He's a great guy.
Right.
And honestly, he didn't really hit the block until, once or twice, whatever it was.
Yeah.
Like, he played a really clean game, in my opinion. So
I thought the guys screwed up by voting him out.
Paul didn't. Yeah. Oh, you mean Paul selecting him final two?
I think they could have kept you, and it would have worked to their advantage.
1,000,000%. And that's what I told Victor when he got evicted. I was like, it's funny because you got out right after me, and I was the only person that wasn't going to put you up on the block if I won HOH.
You were also playing it more with strategy, where James is just like, well, you were nice to me earlier in the season. Mm-hmm. Me and you were buddies, you know, but I don't think that he had the sense of strategy that you had. And I'm a strategy fan of Bubble. I don't care who stands on top of a pole the longest and who can throw a duck through a... All that stuff drives me crazy. But the thing that I love is the game changes, your strategy changes with it. And what I love is the fact that people... It's got to be the craziness of the house. People get mad in a way they never would in a game. No one gets mad in baseball if someone's stealing second. You don't say you're a bad person. You stole that base. But they get really mad at this game.
I agree with that 100%. People get really... I mean, it's a game for $500,000. So I can only imagine the fans outside in the world and and us playing it. But I do feel like strategically, like, I played a really smart game moving forward. Like, I observed, you know, I used my strengths to get through the game. And a lot of fans afterwards were telling me that I was very in tune with my gameplay. Mm-hmm. Like, I was calling things and calling out different alliances. And they're like, you hit it right on the spot and you weren't even in the room with them. So
right. But then James is like, no, I don't know. I don't think so.
Honestly, James was chilling. No, to be honest, I'll defend James. He just played a really clean game. He didn't get himself in any messes, and he was able to not hit the block. Yeah. Did he not have to work as hard as everyone else? No, but I mean, I feel like that's smart in and of itself.
Yeah, there's just all different ways to play it.
You know,
sometimes people, you come in and you're aggressive, and a lot of times it's better just to not do anything for 9 or 10 weeks, which is intensely hard. That's intensely hard.
Some people slept, right?
Yeah.
Some people slept in the beginning.
You sleep a lot. You sleep, eat, and sleep some more, and gossip. That's all you do in the house.
I remember when they used to smoke on the show, the smokers would go outside.
Oh, you can still smoke outside. Yeah.
They just don't air it, right?
I don't know.
Oh, is that right? Because that seems like a good way of acting like... Well, we're not friends, but we're just both smoking, and then you could get a little plan going.
I don't think that anyone in my season really smoked, so maybe that's why.
Who's your all-time favorite player that's played the game?
In all of history, honestly, I was never a big gamer, but I really like Rachel Riley. I heard she's pretty awesome, and I really support her. I mean, she's a badass chick.
She actually came in rough, you know what I mean? Like, she played as the target, went out for it every week. Normally, we could say that's a bad thing, but if you win, it works. Just like any other game, any other sport, if it works, it works, and you can't get upset with that.
It's funny because you can come in one season with, you know, one personality, and you can be loved, but if there's a different dynamic in another season, you could be hated. It really depends on, you know, the people you're with.
So you guys grew up in Venezuela, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So
Venezuela.
Moving here had to be an incredible culture shock, right?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I mean, we were a little bilingual. Spanish was our first language. So when we moved back, the first place that we remember was Tampa, like the first American place.
Yeah.
And so that was weird. Even though, you know, I was a little intimidated by people with blue eyes and like super blonde hair. I was like, whoa, like these are Americans.
Yeah. Even though you were born with blonde hair. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I had it a lot harder than her because I was younger and I was in ESL for 2 years. I got held back, so I couldn't speak
first
English.
First grade.
It was really hard. It was really
tough, tough grade.
I couldn't understand anyone.
So to do that, when you adapt to that type of thing, that might even help you with the game, right? That ability.
1,000,000%.
Yeah.
It definitely did.
To just change your reality for a little kid.
Yeah.
And we moved around a little bit with you, and I remember your personality would change depending on the school.
Yeah, and also, like, you're going to change anyway because you're young, but you kind of get this, like, reset button where you're like, okay, now if I'm going to walk into this situation, especially after you've done it a couple times, you kind of just can assess, like, okay, who do I want to, like, what do I want to put forward in this new experience?
Yeah.
And kids will change anyway. You know what I mean? Like, you're already, like, trying to figure yourself out.
But then you look at Chris. He lives in the apartment he was born in, and you've never crossed the Hudson River yet.
Not yet.
What?
Not yet.
Yeah.
He's crossed the East River.
All right, after the show, we're going.
Why don't you take a Jersey trip?
Oh, that's a good starter trip.
Bust my cherry.
Jersey's fun, I promise.
I just saw a thing on NJ.com today where they were saying South Jersey better than North Jersey. They gave like 15 different reasons. And the Jersey people are fighting with each other. That is a state
That's a great way to divide the people and get different votes.
Yeah. Even when Hillary's trying to bring us all together.
I'm sure her intentions are all pure.
You're going to be doing your Big Brother show that you do with Vito.
Big Brother and the Holding Company, yes, the podcast.
Yeah, how is that doing right now?
It's doing very well. It's doing really well.
And Natalie is your first big celebrity guest on the show?
Yes, that would be beautiful.
Where she is in your favorite players from her season?
It's, all right, it's Natalie, it's Frank, and it's Pauly.
Yes!
Paul. Really?
Paul. Yeah.
Yes!
Pauly, I lost it.
Frank was a shark.
Yeah, he was.
Well, he was a shark, but he just got in too deep towards the middle.
Here's the thing. Nobody played harder than Paul. Nobody changed his game more than Paul.
Amazing.
I mean, he came in as the creep. And,
yes.
You know, two got voted out. And he's like, hey, I'm a nice guy. Yeah. And no, I was like, I love
Paul
that.
Paul played a phenomenal game.
Yeah.
He was able to adapt to his surroundings. This kid is intelligent.
Yeah.
I'll give him that. He's very, very smart.
And he couldn't have started lower. Like, I think everybody right away, they were
on the hit list. He was on the
They were like, this guy's pretty
the
annoying.
Guy with the beard.
APAC wanted to hit. He was on the top of the hit list. Him and Victor and Jose.
And he turned it around, and that's always amazing. Now, you watching this online season that these guys are watching?
Big Brother Over the Top?
Yeah.
No, but I do see a cut, like, Big Meech and my stuff is still in the house somehow. Like, they find my bracelet, so they play with it. They found Meech's bra the other day, so they've been playing with it.
That is so like, crazy. Yeah.
So they hilarious.
They didn't really clean the house.
They lost, all of them lost a lot of stuff, I hear. They couldn't find, like,
You lose things in the house, and, like, honestly, we, like, probably, like, place things in drawers, like, deep down inside, because you try to hide your things sometimes, too.
Yeah.
So I guess we did a good job hiding things.
Well, they've never done two seasons so close
back to
together.
Back. It was literally like a couple days after. Like it was really,
It was a week between seasons.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So that's going to be where, Chris?
That's going to be on the Interrobang.com. That's Big Brother and the Holding Company.
All right. When's the new episode come out?
Tomorrow. It will come out tomorrow.
All right. So we're going to end this show. We're going to run down and try to see Sting again.
Yes.
Sting is singing. And he sounds unbelievable. He's down in our lobby. And he looks unbelievable.
He's ripped.
Yeah,
I think he's 61 or 62 years old.
He looks better than most guys walking around the city.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah. My sister fangirled out, and
did
I've
you?
Never seen her fangirl out before.
He's not like my style, but he looks great.
Yeah. Not. But also, by the way, he's got $670 million or something crazy like that. I mean, he's got one of the most successful careers of all time. And that's David Frick, by the way, from Rolling Stone magazine.
Oh, wow.
Is interviewing. So David Frick has been one of the great rock journalists of all time. That's really cool to be able to see those guys sit down and do that.
Yeah, well, we came around the corner just hearing his voice. I was like, wow, he still sounds fantastic.
I know. He still sounds like it's 1983.
Yeah, he has the same voice.
And he's swagger, too. I like the whole
Oh, yeah.
Like turtleneck and like jean thing going on. I was like, wow, I got to get me that outfit.
Watch a movie called Quadrophenia when Sting was young. He never says a word in it, and he's the center of the movie. And he doesn't talk at all. People talk about him. It's amazing. It's an amazing performance.
No, we should get you a show like that where you don't have to talk. You just
sit. No, there and other people
I like talking
it.
Too much.
Natalie and Stephanie Negroni have been in the studio. The Jolly Cruise with Natalie and James from Big Brother and Carnival Cruise Lines set sail Sunday, April 2nd, returns Sunday, April 9th. Portions of the proceeds from the event will go towards the Bullies Reality Foundation. On Twitter, it's Natalia Negroni.
Woo!
All right. That's it for us. All Thanks right. so much, everybody. Thank you guys
for
being here.
Thanks for having us.
It was really a pleasure to meet you both.